40. Coaches and girls team. Both seniors athletes are Grayson Rice, daughter of Heather and John Rice. Grayson played tennis for 1 year. One of her favorite memories includes getting permission to play with Freddie. My advice to younger athletes is this. Don't work with what you practice, and don't argue with your opponent. He's always right. After graduation, Grayson plans to attend USI and earn a teaching degree. She would like to come back to Carmine and teach history. Sophia Smith is the daughter of Amanda and Aaron Smith. Sophia has played tennis for 2 years. After graduation, Gage plans to attend Savannah College of Art and Design to pursue a creative career. Zach Burrell is a He has played golf for all 4 years of high school. He offers this advice for younger athletes. Just have fun. It goes by fast. Sailor Mason is the daughter of Jessica and Trey Mason. Sailor has played golf for all 4 years of high school. Her favorite things about it are the bus rides and going out there to the team. One piece of advice that Sailor offers to younger athletes is to try to stay positive even when you aren't playing your best. After graduation, she plans to further her education at Mississippi State University. From the cheerleading squad, coach by Nikki Whitney, Mackenzie Pringle is the daughter of Harry and Josh Carpenter. Ken and Justin Pringle. Mackenzie has been cheering for 13 years. She has loved watching her team grow throughout the years and get better before they play. Mackenzie said, as a wise woman once told me, always give your 110% because hard work beats talent. After graduation, she plans to attend Clifton University and major in finance to become an accountant. Emma Rader is the daughter of Amy and John Rader. Emma has been touring for 7 years. She says that the reason she works hard. She cheers is because she loves being a part of the team and experiencing all the laughter and tears together. Her favorite memory is when she was in the game. She wanted to tell her and her advice to not be afraid of breaking out of herself and displaying your personality. After graduation, she hopes to go to a four-year university and major in advertising and minor in graphic design or art design. Britta Russell is the daughter of Grace and Holly Russell. Britta has been cheering for 2 years. She said, my favorite part of being a cheerleader is having the opportunity to be a part of something that brings our whole community together.
Brenna also has some advice for younger cheerleaders.
Don't ever be afraid to try something new. I started training my junior year and absolutely loved it. After graduation, she placed her pin before a four-year university, majored in political science, and go to law school to pursue a career as an attorney. Emma for Shelby's 7 years. Emma's favorite part of her career is when her friends and her family dine out. Tailgating her four games, celebrating with everyone during any victory tournament after a win. Even during the really cold games, try to have fun with the basketball game will come back to when you want to.
Lauren Lake is the son of Brian and Ellen Lake.
He's played football for 8 years.
gentlemen, tonight's contest is visiting Cora Wolf and your partner, White Tony Bulldog. First, let's meet the visiting Cora Wolf. Number 30, senior, defensive back, Jamin Cook. Number 4, junior, defensive back, Logan Atwood. Number 7, a senior, defensive back, Malachi Tolliver. Number 10, a senior, defensive back, John McGee. Number 50, a senior, defensive line, Jeffrey Mitchell. Number 19, a senior, linebacker, Liam O'Donnell. Number 36, a senior, linebacker, Bo Brooks. Number 60, a senior, defensive line, Dave DeFalco. Number 69, a senior, defensive line, Kate Lusenby. Number 74, a senior, defensive line, Eli Trust. And number 78, a senior, defensive line, Riley Fuller. Coaches are Brian Tackett, Scott Will, John Wallace, Cody Glassford, and Curtis. And now, Bulldog fans, put your hands together. It's me, your Bulldog fans. Bulldog fans,
see a heavy dose of number one to start this drive, and why not? We're going to keep our eye on our stats guy, Toby Brown, down there on the sideline, and from the thumbs up from our laptop man, the boss man, J.C. Tinsley, we think we've got some audio on the YouTube stream, so that's Fantastic. We were trying to work with that. Like I said, I apologize for the fans at home. I know we've had some issues on the YouTube stream this season, had some issues last week with some internet, but a lot of moving parts got to combine to make that happen.
If you're wondering how many yards he needs, he needs to get to 4,098 to get the record.
65 away from the record. He's got the kickoff from the 20-yard line. King looking for running room. He'll take it across the 30-yard line up to the Bulldog 34, and we're underway here at Harrington Jeffries Sports Complex. It's the Bulldogs and the Wolves.
And Wolves looking at them warm-ups. Team with some decent size up front, some good-sized linemen, decent skill positions, so be interesting to see how the Bulldogs come out this opening drive.
Bulldogs do start this drive from their own 35. Under center is Warren Legg. Bulldogs come out in the power eye formation. King dots that eye. He gets the handoff up the middle off the right side. King is going to stumble his way across the 40, so there's 6 yards for Isaac. 41-yard line.
And like most teams this year, 9 men in the box. It's kind of... They literally, four linebackers, I mean, two of them obviously corners, but they were just stacked in the box next to each other. It was literally a 5-4, two safeties back. I haven't seen four linebackers stacked in the box like that from anyone this year.
Second down and 4 for the Bulldogs from their own 41-yard line. Leg under center, toss right side to King, left side. King's got blockers across midfield, takes it across the 45, and is dragged down inside the 40-yard line to the 37. That's a rush of play. It's first down and a big bustage of yards that time for Isaac King and a first down.
Beautifully set up. Again, if you're going to play 9 guys inside the box, that's why I was just surprised how Flores lining 4 guys inside the ends. I mean, you're really exposing the outside when you do that. That toss was just easy as can be for the Bulldogs that last play.
First and 10 from the 38-yard line of Flora. Under center is Legg. They go to Odd off the right side. Odd nearly broke that one, took it inside. And the ball come
it
out?
It did. When he was spinning, it came out.
Odd fumbled the football, and yeah. Flora has recovered. Wow. Carmine turns the ball over just the 5th time on the season, and Flora takes over at their own 39.
When he was fighting for that extra yardage, I noticed he kind of spun, and when he did, it looked like his arm kind of came wide, and that ball popped out.
So this drive comes to a screeching halt for the Bulldogs. And so Flora will take over at their own 39-yard line. So if you're the Wolves, here you go. We talked about it. This Flora team has to win to get into the playoffs. Tolliver, the quarterback, going to run it off the left side. And Tolliver will take it just shy of the 45 at the 44. Chris, I put in the article earlier today on WRUL.com that this is a Flora team that likes to use Malachi Tolliver, their quarterback. He's their leading rusher. They're going to use him a lot like El Dorado used Parker Price 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, he's a dangerous football player, and he just showed you right there with a little quarterback counter inside. He carried for 5 yards. He can do some things. This Flora team is athletic. They spread the ball, and they are dangerous. And let's see if they can take advantage of a Bulldog turnover. Not the way you want to start the game if you're Carmine. You wanted to establish yourselves, get rid of the sting from last week, and this isn't the way to start a game.
Second down and 5 for Flora at their own 43-yard line. Tolliver, quick wide receiver screen, and making the catch and turning up field for a gain of about 3 there. If I can find my Flora roster, which I have misplaced, it's back here behind me. That's no good. That was number 7 with the catch. That was Tolliver who actually caught the ball.
Yeah, they kind of switch
things around.
Yeah, quick screen there. Again, the philosophy, get the ball in the hands of your best athlete. And thought he was going to be tackled for a loss, but he made a nice cut to the inside. Bulldogs over pursued a little. And in a game like this, this may be 4-down territory for Flora.
3rd down and 2 from the Flora 47-yard line. In the shotgun is the quarterback. That is Stalver, who's in the shotgun. Moves a man in motion. They run it
off the gut, and that is going to be a 4 first down.
Taking it up to midfield. A flag flies in at the end from the back judge.
And that was late in the play, so it's always 1 of 2. It's either a hold or a face mask. It looks like it's going to be against the wall, so talking to the Bulldogs captain.
I believe that was John McGee, number 10, who got the carry, and the flag came in towards the end of the play.
See if they called.
as a hold.
They're going to say a hold against Florida, so that takes away that first down run.
Much needed break there for the Bulldogs.
That happened to Comrie a couple of times last week, having a nice first down run that was called back with a hold.
Yeah.
We'll stop that there.
We can get a lot of comments on that one.
Third down and 7 here for Flora. They're going to send one receiver each side, a tight end off the ball on each side, and Malachi Tolliver in the shotgun. Move a man in motion. Tolliver, they hand it off up the middle. This is number 19, the ball carrier. That is Liam O'Donnell. And O'Donnell gets about a yard up to the 42-yard line. And we're going to see the Flora punt team. So the Bulldogs turn the ball over just the fifth time this season, but it does not hurt them as the Wolves will punt this one away.
Well, like we say, you know, penalties can hurt you, and that was a drive killer for the Wolves there because they had something going there for a couple plays.
Tolliver will punt this one away. A pretty good punt. Landon Driscoll falls back and muffs it initially, but he
did
able to
fall.
Fair catch made at the 15-yard line. So first down and 10 for Carmi at that spot. Give me an update, Isaac King. He's at 28 yards on the night. So that means he is just 37 away from
time.
Is that how is that time or breaking? How about you just bust one off so we call it good?
Yeah, that way we're going out the count.
And again, we're keeping an eye on our stats guy, Toby Brown and his crew.
Big shout out to them, mm-hmm. The job they do week in and week out.
Brian Weaver and Roger Horton also with him on the sideline. First and 10 for the Bulldogs from their own 15-yard line. Hand off to King, left side. King gets across the 20-yard line, across the 30. 30, oh, he almost broke it. Brought down at the 31-yard line. That's about a 15-yard pickup for Isaac and a rush upon its first down.
The Flores linebacker there just saved a touchdown. Wow, that was, I believe that was number 17, Alex Tree on the tackle. But King, one tackle from busting that one out. Just a good inside counter run like he's done all season. Let's see the Bulldogs keep this going. Flores, 9 men in the box. I'd like to see another toss play.
Well, let's go to the T formation. They give it off to Odd left side. And Draxon will take it up across the 35 to the 36-yard line. About a 5-yard pickup, second and 5 coming up.
That's been Drax's bread and butter play all year, the 23 crossbuck. He's always been good for about 5-6 yards on that play. Been consistent all year. So, again, Carmike can just tonight just do what they do. You know, I think they have confidence offensively against this Wolves defense. The big thing is us getting 3 and outs when the Wolves have the ball.
Second down and 5 under center's leg. They fake the toss, go counter right side to King. King's got running room. He takes it across the 45 to the 46-yard line. About an 8-yard pickup there for Isaac King. That's enough for a rush to play its first down. With 7 minutes to go in this first quarter of a scoreless first quarter.
Well, that was the play last week that was just nothing doing for us. But tonight it's been so far really consistent. The wing comes in motion from the left side. The backs both fake, plant, and turn. Run the counter back to the right side. Well executed.
Leg under center in the T formation. Ball at the Carmi 45-yard line. They turn. Give it off to King on the right side. King trying to... And that might be it.
He's at 53.
Gain of 15. That's a Bulldog first down. And that's it.
He's got it.
Isaac King is the all-time leading rusher in Carmi White County history with that first down run up to the Cesar 40, the Flora 42-yard line. Congratulations to Isaac King. History here tonight in Carmi.
What an outstanding young man. Pleasure to watch. Congratulations, Isaac.
Bulldogs right back to the line of scrimmage. They give it off to King, left side, trying to find the edge. And he'll plow his way up inside the 40.
Tack on 5 more now that you've made history. So took about 5 Wolves with him there. And they're going to announce it. And deservedly so, the crowd coming to its feet. Congratulate this young man on an outstanding varsity career.
You hear the roar from the crowd.
And I'll clap with them.
As they rise to their feet, Isaac King breaks a record that, again, a lot of people thought would never be broke. under center of his leg here on second down. They get off the odd up the middle, and I will take it up to the 35-yard line.
Well, we got Subin on that left side. Chase Pringle and Nelson Ryder, kind of a combo block there. Took that down lineman about 7 yards downfield. Odd could kind of walk behind that one for some chunks of yards. So nice job on the left side that time.
5.5 to play in this first quarter. Third down and 4 here for Carmi at the 35-yard line. Under center his leg in the power eye formation. They get off to King up the middle, and King will plow his way up inside the 30. Got to the 30, or the 31 possibly. He should have enough for a first down. They might measure.
Yeah, it's really close. From the far side, it looks like he's got it. From this side, see if they're going to mark. Yeah, they're going to measure. Yeah,
definitely four down territory if you don't get it, but the football at the 4 of 31.
Yeah. And Carmi here obviously just taking their time this drive, you can tell. Nothing exotic with the play calling. They're just going to keep the ball as long as they can. This is the Wolf style of offense. They do like to, as the old word, matriculate the ball down the field a little quicker. So contrast to styles, but Carmi looking good this second drive.
So they bring out the,
I'm going to say you got it,
the chain gang to measure this one. And again, if he didn't get it, he's going to be
an inch,
less than a yard short. And they're going to say first down, Carmi. So a rush appliance first down up to the Flora 31-yard line. And so that will move the chains.
And again, you know, I think we might try to hit the edge if we come out in the wing. Either sweep right or sweep left, because the way they're, I mean, really packing that box with that four linebacker stack, those edges are there for the Bulldogs if they want it.
5 minutes to go in this scoreless first quarter. Bulldogs trying to strike first. They fumbled on their first drive. Trying to find the end zone here. First down and 10. Led will give it off to King off the left side, and King's got the outside edge at the 25-20, and he is taken down out of bounds inside the 15, and that's a little bit of a late hit, and the officials think so. A penalty flag comes in at the end of the play. It's going to be first and goal for Carmi.
Yes, it is. This time they ran the counter to the left. Both backs stutter step to the right. He got a fantastic kickout block from Bryson Moore from his right guard position. Comes from his right guard, goes to the left, kicks out the defensive end. The stutter motion by the fullback and tailback lead through. Hole was wide open. Isaac did what he's done all year.
So they call a horse. It's a horse collar tackle against Flora at the end of the play. So that will set up first and goal for Carmi inside the 10. They'll mark it at the Flora 6-yard line.
If that's a horse collar, they just tackle a thoroughbred, I can tell you that.
Whatever you need to get him down, apparently.
Yeah.
So Carmi will come out in the T formation here on first and goal from the 6-yard line. Under center his leg. He waits. He will take the snap. He'll give it off to Odd. Second man through the left side. Draxton Odd. Touchdown. Carmi, right 20. A 6-yard run for Draxton Odd. And the Bulldogs strike first at 6-0 with 4:37 to go in the first quarter.
His bread and butter play, the 23 crossback, Odd off left tackle. Again, been there all year. Two Florida defenders in the backfield. He kind of just did the old sliding down the hallway between people. Slid right through him, turned his body, got skinny, and got right in the end zone. Good answer by the Bulldogs after that fumble in the opening possession.
That's a new one. Sliding down the hallway, trying to...
You know, when the hallway's cracking, you kind of turn your body. Yeah,
that's a good one.
Yeah, have to write that one down.
Carmi's going to go for two. They'll go same play right back to Jackson, and he goes right back in the end zone to make it an 8-0 Carmi lead with 4:37 to go here in the first quarter. We'll take a 30-second break. It's Bulldog football here on 97.3 WRUF.
face mask penalty would be, if I'm correct on that. Do you know if I'm correct? I guess I'm asking.
15-yard penalty? Sorry. Not a spot foul in the NFL. It's just, it is in the NFL, but not in high school. So just
high school,
15
college, I think, same thing in college. Yeah. Yep.
So first and 10 for Flora from midfield, and somebody on the Flora offensive line.
Way off. Let's say call us. See who they talk to.
Usually when the, well, you never know sometimes. Usually when the O lineman
signaling false start. Yep.
That will back the Wolves up 5 yards to their own 45. Game 3:01 to go here in the first quarter. Carmine leading Flora 8-0.
When you see the offensive lineman just turn around and walk back, you know he's guilty. If he's pointing at the D lineman, then it's a different story.
First down and 15. Tolliver with the fullback give up the middle. And the ball might have came out there at the end.
I sure thought it did. Looks like they recovered it. I saw it on the ground, yeah. The Wolves did recover.
Looks like McGee and Auburn fighting for it, but McGee was the one that was able to recover it. So Flora catches a break there. Still a gain of 5, though, up to midfield. It'll be 2nd and 10.
They kind of changed their formation on that last one. They went to an I formation with the lead fullback and just ran a dive right at us and got about 7 yards on that before we got him down.
So 2nd down and 10 for Flora from midfield. 2:23 to play in this first quarter. Tolliver under center. He's waiting for something. Now he goes under center. Two running backs behind him. They toss one on the far side. This is McDonald, the ball carrier. He'll get it up into Bulldog territory to the Carmine 47-yard line. It'll bring up 3rd down and 7 here for the Wolves.
Well, like I said, Flora has changed their formation a little bit. They're trying to put a fullback in the backfield, adjusted to an I formation, just to help their running game a little bit, get a lead blocker in front of the tailback. So the Bulldogs went back to their five-man front when they did that. Let's see if the Wolves stay in that or if they try to spread it out some more. I think looks like they're going to go back to their traditional spread here with four wide.
It's probably 4 down territory here for Flora if they don't get it. 3rd down and 7 from the Carmine 47. Tolliver in the shotgun, takes a snap. Bulldogs bring pressure. Tolliver steps up, tries to take off. He's got nowhere to go. Eli Ryan drags him down, as well as Nelson Reiner at the 45. Tolliver was able to fall forward and get positive yardage, so it won't be a sack for Bryant.
Well, that was a big play by Eli Bryant, because we've seen Tolliver with his speed tonight. And if Bryant wasn't there, he had a lot of running room.
Yeah, he's the team's leading rusher. Tolliver is.
Thought that might have possibly been a called quarterback draw. It wasn't, but had it been, it might have been a different story.
So we'll see if Flora wants to put the ball in the air here on 4th down and 4, under a minute to go in this first quarter. Carlisle leads 8-0. Flora has the football at the Bulldog 44-yard line. And the shotgun is Tolliver. He takes the snap. Bulldogs bring pressure again. Tolliver steps up, tries to run through it. He's going to have the first down inside the Carmine 40. And I'll tell you what, Chris, that might have been a busted play, because I'm not sure the offensive line expected that ball to be snapped.
No.
It was about 3 Bulldog defenders who shot through, and Tolliver able to sneak away for a first down.
Well, Odd was coming off the edge on a blitz, and the right side hadn't even moved. So Tolliver just made the most of that one right there. And our defenders were so far off those receivers, I thought he was going to throw an out route. But, again, he just used his athleticism and got a first down there. And with the Bulldogs 4th and 5, you have to know he's their most dangerous weapon and can't allow him to get a first down on that.
That will be the final play of the first quarter. So we go to the second stanza. Your score, Carmine White County 8, 4-0. Back here in 1 minute on 97.3 WRUL. for Flora at the Carmi 37-yard line. Cole Carter and Chris Myers, the Wolves putting together a pretty good drive here on their second possession. They converted a fourth down and four a few seconds ago. And so now they resume things at the Carmi 37. 8-0 Bulldogs. Wolves go under center. They send a wide receiver to each side in the I formation. Under center is Tolliver. Tolliver will turn, gives it off. No, they're gonna run a sweep here to the near side. O'Donnell has the football, and O'Donnell will take it down to the 31-yard line. Seen the Steelers run that play about 100 times this season. Yeah. The old wide receiver toss, jet sweep, and got about 5 yards there.
Well, nice change of pace there. Good job by Tyler Gomack coming up and stopping that, because I think I, like a lot of fans, was watching the fullback on that, the tailback, and it was a very nice fake. Hit the wing coming around, or the receiver coming around. Just a nice game by the Wolves. And if Flora's doing anything this drive, even if they don't score here, what they've accomplished is they've taken a lot of time off the clock this half, kept the ball out of Carmi's hands.
Second down and six, ball at the Bulldog 32-yard line. They give it off up the middle. Number 10, the ball carry, that's McGee. And McGee will take it up inside the 30.
Kind of the same play going the other way that time. Bulldogs on it this time with, you know, third and about four here. You know, if you're Carmi, you want to come up with a stop, because the longer the Wolves drive with this football, the more confidence they're getting. And remember, they get the ball to start the second half of this game this week, just like Johnson City last week. So
third down and four here for Flora at the Carmi 30-yard line. Under center is Tolliver, a wide receiver each side. They move a man in motion, that's McDonald. They toss it near side. Running with the football is Probes. He'll turn up field, and Probes will get out of bounds.
He's got it.
Carmi 21, and he does have a first down.
Well, that was another good play call, and he got a fantastic block from his fullback there on that end around. Just kind of almost like a jet sweep with the fullback leading the block. He got around the left side there, and his fullback got a good block on the end, Dodson, and allowed him to get that first down. And if you're the Flora Wolves,
you feel pretty good.
Very good. Yeah. I mean, after you just had a three and out and punted, and the Bulldogs just took it right down to you, or on you, so to speak. I mean, this is a nice drive they put together.
So first down and 10 for Flora from the Carmi 21-yard line. Tall moves a man in motion. He's going to run a quarterback run up the middle. He got tripped up. Bryson Moore was able to come up and trip him before he got to the outside. About a 1 yard pickup there for Tolliver, second down.
Well, that's just an old veteran move by Bryson Moore, because he wouldn't wrap him up, but he was able to just trip him. And if he hadn't tripped him, that was going to be a bigger gain than what it was.
We haven't seen Flora really go to that downhill running with Tolliver like we assumed they would. I mean, he's their leading rusher. He's carried it over 92 times coming into this ball game.
This kid's 6'3", 190, and he is a heck of an athlete.
He's a good basketball player as well.
Yeah.
We'll see that here in a couple of weeks. Tolliver in the shotgun, two receivers each side, going to throw it over the middle, almost intercepted, back into the hands, and caught first down.
They did call it a catch. Oh, my gosh. Wow.
Driscoll and Odd fought for it in midair, and coming down with the football for a catch was Garrett Petrich.
That's one you had to watch live to see that happen.
They're saying short of a first down. The ball's at the 12-yard line, but, man, Carmi had two, three attempts to pick that one off. Driscoll and Odd fought for it.
Bounce in the air.
And Patrick's able to catch it.
What a break for Flora.
Third down and one from the Carmi 12. Tolliver in the shotgun. Lose a man in motion. Now they hand it off up the middle and trying to bounce it on the left side, putting his shoulder down. That's Popes, the ball carrier. That's going to be a Flora first down. First and goal inside the 10. That was an angry run that time on number 19. Actually, it was O'Donnell, the ball carrier. Liam O'Donnell, first down Wolves.
Fantastic run by O'Donnell. So I'm telling you, he was stymied up the middle. We just didn't wrap up. And we were there, but you got to wrap up when you make that initial contact. Didn't happen, and that was a very angry, determined run, and got the Wolves the first down. Now they're first and goal.
It's been a very impressive drive here for Flora. Now first and goal from the 5-yard line. 8.5 to play. 8-0 Carmi. In the shotgun is Tolliver, has a man behind him, moves a man in motion. Now they run the quarterback crawl on the right side for Tolliver, and he gets taken down, tripped up by Caleb Sievers. Shot through for the tackle.
That was a big play. It stopped him at the line of scrimmage. Because right now, this Wolves offense has just marched the ball down the field here on the Bulldogs, and we've had no answer.
8 minutes to go here in the second quarter. 8-0 Carmi. Four has the football at the Bulldog 5 for a second and goal.
And you can see kind of just in the body language of our defense, just not a ton of energy right now, to be honest. So we really need to make a big play here.
Tolliver in the shotgun now moves the tight end on his right side. One receiver to each side. Tolliver back to pass. Throws one over the middle. That one's tipped in the air and incomplete.
Gavin Payton. He sure did. He said, look at this. I see gold landing. You know, he went to catch that thing, just missed it.
And that's always a scary thought for the offense when you see a ball get tipped up in the air like that. It was the same play that Patridge caught the pass earlier on the tip. Driscoll came up and knocked it in the air. And so now on third down, man, I'll tell you what, if you're Flora, I'm sticking to the run game. I mean, the pass game just hasn't been. They've been very successful on the ground on this drive.
Those jet sweeps have worked well, and, you know, Tolliver, it's not too shabby running the ball. You might look at him, too.
Tolliver on the shotgun. They toss it right side. This is Pope's, the ball carrier, and he is he in the end zone waiting for a signal? Touchdown, Flora. A 5-yard touchdown run from Bo Propes. And the Wolves get on the board with 7:27 to go in the second quarter.
An absolutely impressive drive by the Flora Wolves. They did benefit from a lucky bounce there on a third, second and long play to set up third and two, but give them credit. They did the rest on their own. And this Carmi Bulldog team now knows they're in a fight tonight.
Again, you go against a team that's 4-4, trying to get into the playoffs.
Yeah.
You got to be ready. Four will go for two. They toss it to Pope's left side, and Pope's is in untouched. And ladies and gentlemen, with 7:27 to go in the second quarter, we're tied at 8. We'll take a 30-second break right here on 97.3 WRUL. Yikes. Of 60 plus yards, and all of a sudden we're tied at 8.
I think it's, you know, safe to say a couple things. This Bulldog defense is just still, I think, kind of reeling from last week.
Yeah.
You know, offensively you're not concerned, but Flora took that ball down with ease. They just methodically marched that thing.
Isaac King on the kickoff return from his own 20-yard line, now bouncing it on the far sideline. King trying to turn upfield and gets tripped up at the Bulldog 41-yard line. So first and 10 for Carmi at that spot. So the Wolves capped that drive off with a 6-yard run by Bo Propes.
And it was just small chunks of yards.
Yep. They had the big first down conversion on the tipped pass.
And that sparked it. You know, that tip pass, sometimes you just need a break. And they got a break that last drive. So Carmi has to answer here. Again, obviously no need to panic. Carmi doesn't have to change what they do by any means.
Under center his leg here on first down. They're on the counter play on the left side. Here's King trying to bounce it across the 45-yard line. Tripped up at the Bulldog 36. About a 5-yard pickup.
And that play is going to be there all night.
And Chris, something I've noticed, Carmi just rushed in a new offensive lineman. It's Connor Buchanan, who is now in at left guard, as I see Gavin Payton on the Bulldog sideline. So Carmi trying to
switch things up in terms of personnel on the offensive line.
Yeah, not sure what Gavin has going on down there. Trainer talking to him, so hopefully he's all right.
Second down and four, ball at the Bulldog 46-yard line. Under center his leg. They'll give it off to Odd, left side. Odd's got the first down across midfield. Rexon puts his head down. He's got a Bulldog first down up to the 45-yard line. That's a Rush Appliance first down. Move the chains.
Well, there you go. Odd on the crossback once again. You know, I will say I don't have any concerns about us moving the ball up the field. Offense is going to do what they do. I just think we take care of the ball in this drive, get it down and score. Our defense really needs to step up because you're a week away from the playoffs, and it's, you know, has to be somewhat concerning how Florida just methodically marched that ball down on us.
So first and 10 for Carmi from the 4:45. They toss it King near side, waiting for his blockers. Now gets to the outside inside the 35, and he's pushed out of bounds near the 30. And another flag comes in. It's going to be a late hit against Flora as they hit King when he went out of bounds. That was number 60.
Yeah, that looks like
Gabe Ivanko hit him late.
And that's a backbreaker for Flora. If you're Flora's coach, Brian Tackett, you got to be over there thinking, boys, we just answered the bell with the score, and now we're just we don't need to give this Carmi team any freebies.
So, assuming it's going to be a 15-yard penalty at the end of the run, look for the officials to discuss and figure out where they're going to mark the football. They're going to say a necessary roughness against Flora, so at 15 yards at the end of the King run, this will put the football all the way at the, let's see here, 4, 20, 19, 18. Well, you just keep on walking. We appreciate it.
Yeah.
They're going to stop
and take it on down the goal line if you want.
And they're going to stop at the 4:17. So it's going to be first and 10 for Carmi at that spot. 6:07 to go here in the second quarter. 8-8 your score. Under center his leg with a wing back to the left side. They give it off to Odd, off the left side. Big hole for Odd. He's going to put his shoulder down inside the 10 to the Flora 9-yard line. Maybe 8. Second down coming up. Second and short here for Carmi.
I think we should be able to punch this in a play or two. I'm trying to call things ahead.
Hey, Chris, you know, there's been a couple of times this year where, you know, Carmi has allowed a score to kind of let a team get in the ball game. You think Fairfield, you think even Vienna or CZR, but you can only hold this Bulldog team out of the end zone so long.
Yeah, you can't play behind against us.
They give it off to Odd off the right side, and Odd will take it up near the 6. That should be enough for a first down. Well, you can't play behind unless you're Johnson City.
Right.
The Bulldogs had a 15-point lead last week, and the Indians with a great second and third quarter to come back and win that game.
And again, you know, we don't want to make it seem like, you know, I'm not like you just shut every team out. But a team like Flora that's in desperation mode, you just don't want to let them have any confidence. Exactly. Because they can be dangerous. We've shown. I mean, they've shown Malachi Culver is a good football player, and he can do some things.
In the power formation, a Rush Appliance first and goal here for Carmi. They give it off to King off the left side. Isaac King trying to keep those feet turning, and he's in. Touchdown, Carmi White County.
All right, ISO off the left side. Your lead back's from the crease. You just put your head down, burrow your way in. Classic power football.
And with 4:47 left to go in the second quarter, the Bulldogs reclaim the lead on a 6-yard run by Isaac King. And so the Bulldogs will go for two, try to extend this lead. 14-8 as it stands now. So Legg will walk the offense up to the T formation, the tight T formation that is.
Watch the double go here.
Wolf stacking the box to give it off to Odd on the left side, and Odd will... Is he in? Waiting for a signal. Yes, he is. He's in for two. So with 4:47 to play in the second quarter, your score, Carmi County 16, Flora 8. We'll take a 30-second break right here on 97.3 WRUF.
with you. As Brandon Stockton set to kick this one away.
Good to see him, the senior, getting the kick tonight.
Line drive kick going to be picked up from the 20, or actually bobbled at the 20-yard line and fallen on by Flora at that spot. So it'll be first and 10 for the Wolves with 4:45 to go in the second quarter.
I'd like to see the Carmine defense come out here and just kind of establish themselves. I think it's important mentally that they get a three and out against this Wolves team after they, you know, kind of methodically had their way with us that last drive. I mean, that, you know, obviously that freakish play, that tip pass, kept their drive alive. But, you know, just from the standpoint of kind of getting our mojo back on the defensive side of things, I'd like to see them make a stand here.
So first and 10 for Flora from their own 20-yard line. Tolliver in the shotgun. He's got a wide receiver on each side. Who's a man in motion and a handoff from the jet sweep. This is McGee, the ball carrier, trying to find the edge. McGee's got the first down, and he's taken down out of bounds across the 40-yard line. So on the first play of the drive, Flora bust a long one for a first down.
With that sweep that they run, handing it to the wing back, again, we have to go with the four-man front because of the things they make you do in this formation. But having Tolliver as an extra weapon, that just makes it, you know, you got another man you got to defend back there. So that makes these edge runs a lot more open because your ends have to play a lot tighter in this four-man front.
First and 10 for Flora now from their own 40-yard line. Tolliver back to pass, looking to throw. Still has time, now throws a deep ball on the right side of the field. He's got a man there and is incomplete. Oh, was it caught off the tip? Was it caught off the tip again? It was.
Wow.
Flora with another catch off the deflection and a long one all the way to the Carmine 18-yard line.
It hit his hands in the air as he was going to the ground. It landed on his stomach and he caught it. Two incredible catches. You call them Bray, just good plays by these four receivers. But I'm telling you, Tolliver with an incredible throw.
Got a cannon.
Incredible throw. And the receiver got behind our defense. So great play by Flora. We didn't get any pressure on the quarterback.
So first and 10 now for Flora from the Carmine 18-yard line. Tolliver in the shotgun. Quarterback run left side. And Tolliver is brought down by Bryson Moore at the 15.
And I say we didn't put pressure. We didn't blitz that time, but our ends, because of Tolliver's athletic ability, what our ends have to be careful of is over-pursuing. If our ends come rushing at him too quick and he breaks to the outside, he has that potential to bust a 50, 60-yard run. So we have to honor his running ability. And by doing that, you know, you kind of sacrifice giving him a little more time in the pocket. So he's a dangerous player.
Under center is Tolliver here on second down. They toss on the right side. Probes the ball carrier, trying to change directions. He's going to shed off tacklers and get it inside the 10-yard line. And that might be enough for a Flora first down.
Well, I tell you, Probes is just running like a man possessed tonight. He's just looking to run people, flat out run them over.
You know, 5'9", 180. He's running with fear, with power. He's been hard to bring down tonight.
They're going to mark him third and one.
So third and one from the Carmi 8-yard line. Wolves try to tie this ball game back up. 16-8 your score. Carmi in front. 2:40 left to play in the second quarter. Under center is Tolliver. He's got two receivers on each side. He's back to pass. Tolliver over the middle. Incomplete.
Kind of surprised with that play call there, going for a slant. I mean, you got Tolliver, you got Probst, you need a yard. If I'm Flora, I'm getting the ball in his hands, just letting him run for it, or even sneak it. So, like, kind of did the Bulldogs a favor on that play call. But now if you're Carmine, I mean, you need this. Your defense really needs a stop.
They're going to go for it on fourth down and one from the Carmine 8-yard line. Under center is Tolliver. Probst behind him. Quarterback sneak. Tolliver got stood up initially. Second effort.
That's close.
Depending on what they say, they're going to say enough for a Flora first down.
Yeah.
Initially, on the first effort,
Tolliver got stood up, but he's hard to bring down. 6'3", 190 pounds, and he's able to push for a first down.
Yeah, he just kind of spun his way. It looked like Bryant had him stood up for a second, but he just kind of spun. And being the athlete he is, got where he needed to go and got him the yard they needed. So the Wolves knocking on the door again.
So first and goal from the 7-yard line. Tolliver in the shotgun. They move a man in motion. Now they give it off in the jet sweep. As McGee, the ball carrier, and McGee is in for a Flora touchdown. They run the jet sweep, and from 7 yards out, John McGee is in the end zone, and with 2 minutes to go in the second quarter, it's a two-point game. Wow.
Yeah, that's my sentiments exactly. Flora came to play tonight, the same play. We have had no answer for that jet sweep all night. They line those wideouts out wide. Our corners and safeties have to honor that. But it creates a lot of room out there in space. And if we're not getting pressure off the edge, we're getting creased inside. It creates those opportunities.
We're going to go for two to try to tie the game. Tolliver, quarterback run, left side, and he's in. And we are tied at 16 with 2 minutes to play in the second quarter. Flora fighting for their playoff lives, and they're playing like it. We'll take a 30-second break right here on 97.3 WRUL. Time all year, really you can say yikes after the Bulldog defense comes off the field. Flora again marches down the field and scores to tie the game at 16 with 2 minutes to go here in the second quarter.
And the thing is, Coley made it look easy.
Yeah,
both drives.
Kate Allen here on the kickoff return, now running up the middle, and Allen will take it across the 30-yard line, up just shy of 35, so first and 10 for Carmi on that spot. Well, outside the odd fumble, not too much complaints on the offensive side of the ball, but again, Chris, this defense just kind of seems like they're a little bit still shaken up from last week's game.
Yeah, it's just like the nightmare of the second half of last week has just not stopped. But credit the Wolves because they have a good scheme, and Malachi Tolliver, you know, we say it week to week, some good athletes, you know, he may be the best quarterback that I've seen to this point in the year. Just his arm,
number one,
what he can do with the ball. But his supporting cast offensively has been there for him.
Leg under center here on first down. Toss to King off the right side. Isaac trying to turn upfield. A penalty flag flies in as Isaac gets across the 40. And Ken Carmi just continues to hurt themselves.
That will be a hold.
And Chris, the first thing that comes to my mind is on senior night, things are always a little bit weird because you get a little bit out of your routine in terms of your warm-up, and you got to stop. You really got to interrupt your warm-up halfway through to come to the senior night recognition. Then you're right back into it. So I can recall back from my playing days, that's always a little bit weird to get back into the game mode when you stop for senior night. And, of course, a senior-heavy team, Carmi, is just having a hard time getting in the rhythm of the night.
Yeah, I mean, that's there. You know, you always have that in play. But I think, you know, a couple things. We're just still kind of in shell shock from last week. And number two, Flora Wolves have just outplayed us offensively. I mean, when I say outplayed us, they've just had their will with our defense. I shouldn't say it to the because it's just a tie game. You know, no panic mode for Carmi. But we just got to wake up and play defense.
First down and 18, double handoff here. Now it's Dotson on the left side, and Dotson will take it across the 30 up to the 32-yard line.
Looked like if he made a cut to the right there, he may have busted that one, but got back what we could. But again, just uncharacteristic things. You know, we fumbled tonight. Another penalty on an opening play. Just, you know, when things kind of snowball on you a little bit like they have against our defense, you don't want that poison to spill over to your offense. And so far this drive, it's kind of looking that way.
Second down and 13 here for Carmi. 1:10 to play in the second quarter. Ray gives it off to King on the right side, and King is taken down to the backfield. Flora read the counter play.
They did. He got the block from Peyton, but backside pursuit cut him off. And now we're third and long.
So if I'm Flora, I'd use a timeout. I try to get one score before the end of the half.
It looks like they're not going to. They're just going to be content to get this to halftime and get the first possession. And if you're Carmi, you may not take a risk throwing it here.
Third down and 12. Ball at the Carmi 32-yard line. 35 seconds left to go in the second quarter. Under center is Legg. He takes a snap. They go back to pass here. Legg throws one down the field, and Allen wasn't turned around yet to make the catch. Pass falls incomplete, and it's fourth down.
And we'll have to punt this one away, and Flora is going to have a couple shots at the end zone, depending on where the ball's fielded and what they decide to do.
And keep in mind, Mitchell Edwards, Carmi's normal punter, is out tonight with a concussion. So as I guess you could say, sketchy as special teams always are, now that you're down to your second team punter, always makes that a little more concerning.
And you're deep in your own territory. You want to get a clean snap. So time first and foremost.
Tyler Gomad is back to punt this one away. Play clock down to 8. And a low snap. Gomad can't field it. Picks it up at his own 10-yard line. Gomat's got a run with it. Gomat's got some room. Gomat trying to get to the sticks, and he cannot. Flora's going to get the stop at the 32-yard line with 16 seconds on the clock.
And again, special teams. Kind of been our Achilles heel this season. But now the Wolves with the ball at the Bulldog 42, call it. They're going to have at least two cracks at the end zone here. And we've seen what Tolliver can do with his arm. They've got a legitimate chance to score here.
The pass plays have been everything but easy for Carmi to defend tonight. A couple of passes that go off the hands of Carmi defenders into the hands of four receivers. They're going to have at least two shots in the end zone with 16.3 seconds on the clock.
I'd look to blitz him here.
Tolliver in the shotgun. Bulldogs do bring pressure. Tolliver now rolls out to his right. But correction, it's a different quarterback in the ballgame, and the pass falls incomplete. Number 15, Parker Helm, a freshman, was in there at quarterback, and the pass falls incomplete.
Yeah, Tolliver was actually a receiver on that play.
Well, when you've got Tolliver, who's 6'3", you might as well try get him in a jump ball scenario, but I'm not sure if the backup Helm's got the arm strength that Tolliver does.
No, I'm just the mindset, you leave your horse back there to lead you, you know. He's got a cannon for an arm. They kind of did us a favor that play.
One of your four, you've got time to make this a shorter pass. You're at the 38. You have all three timeouts. Still with 9 seconds to go. And I put Tolliver back in the shotgun. I believe that's Tolliver in the shotgun. Well, I think Tolliver's out wide to the right. This is Helm again in the shotgun. Helm's back to pass here on second down. Now he throws one. Ball's knocked in the air, and it's going to go out of bounds on the Flora sideline with 3.9 seconds. We'll have time for one more play.
A timely pressure by Isaac King coming from the defensive end spot. Did a nice rip move, got underneath the block of the left tackle and got pressure just in time. So one more shot at the end zone for the Wolves. But either way, if you're Flora, you're feeling good coming out in the third quarter.
And again, the Wolves will get the ball to start the third quarter of play. We might see a timeout called here. Play clock down to 10. Both teams have all three timeouts, and Flora will burn a timeout here. So with 3.9 seconds, and really, Chris, if you're Carmi, you just got to send a couple defensive backs down to the goal line and don't let anybody get behind you.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you one thing, Chris. I'd want to be a fly on the wall in that locker room at halftime.
Well, I have to make myself guilty. You know, I think we all just came in tonight thinking, okay, Carmi's going to be fired up senior night, get ready to go in the playoffs, and the Flora Wolf said, hey, we're here too.
And he got that's an easy thing to do.
Very easy. Very easy.
In the minds of 16, 17-year-old kids, we were both there when you're not worried about a team that's 4-4. You're worried about what 16-3 team you're going to face next. It's very easy to do.
I, I just think as much as anything, it's a mental thing coming into tonight for the Bulldogs. It was, because that loss was draining.
Yep.
You know, there was so much at stake in that game, so much hype, so much expectation, and, you know, coming off that loss, it was such an emotional blow, I think, to our team. You know, the big question was, could we get up to play tonight? And offensively, you know, we had been fine up until this last drive. But our defense, again, has just shown signs of just not being there. And so there's going to be a lot of soul searching to do at this halftime break for the Dogs. They got to keep them out here.
Back to passes, Helm. Final play of the first half. He rolls out, now throws one down the field. That is going to be tipped and incomplete. And that is how the first half comes to an end. Wasn't pretty for the Bulldogs. And for Flora, it's about as good as you could ask. Your halftime score, the Bulldogs 16, Flora 16. We'll take a 3-minute break right here on your home for Bulldog football, 97.3 WRUL. This is Bulldog football on 97.3 WRUL, Carmi, Illinois, and also online worldwide at WRUL.com. Cole Carter and Chris Myers, Scott Mearing back at the WRUL studio. J.C. Tinsley and Whitney McGuire here helping on the YouTube video stream side of things. The halftime show is produced courtesy of the Jordan Funeral Group, remembering lives well lived and honoring the tradition of Bulldog athletics. Visit JordanFuneralGroup.com for more information. Well, I think the one word that could be used to describe that first half, yikes.
Yeah.
Carmi just, especially on the defensive side of the football, did not look good. And we were talking to Todd Silverpool in front of us during the break, Chris, and no matter who you play next week, I think this game is the most important game of the year, because you're talking going 8-1 or 7-2. Well,
you don't want to lose this game.
Well, you know, I had talked a few weeks ago, and I, you know, we had the discussion. You never want to back your way into the postseason.
Absolutely.
You know, last week, understandable. I mean,
yeah.
John City team that, you know, is potentially can make a deep playoff run. But coming into tonight, you know, you expected the Bulldogs to rebound and to come out here and play better football. Offensively, we've been fine. You know, this last drive, we made some mistakes. You know, a penalty, something uncharacteristic, had a fumble early, but you're not concerned about our ability to move the football. Defensively, though, I mean, there's a lot of concern.
Yeah.
Because the Wolves, that first drive, they were the beneficiary of a huge break.
Yeah.
A safety and a corner both touched the ball that should have either been intercepted or knocked to the ground. And a fortunate bounce for the Wolves, unfortunate bounce for the Bulldogs allowed them to make a catch and keep a drive alive. That little spark gave them some life, and to their credit, they took it down. So Conway answers right back. So you expect this Bulldog team, four started that drive on their 20, to answer and get them off the field. 80 yards later, they're in the end zone. You know, a long pass. You know, Tolliver shows his cannon arm, throws a long pass downfield, and another break. Ball that bounced right up in the air. The receiver falls to the ground. It lands right on his stomach, and he catches it. And just two sparks of plays keep them alive,
yeah,
and it changes the game.
If you take those two plays away, is it a 22-0 game? Is it a 16-8 game?
Right.
Who knows?
Right.
The two plays that, you know,
kept them alive.
10 times out of 10 are going to happen.
Right.
And so, but at the same time, even if you take those two plays away, Florida has just, there's no question, have come out with more power, more enthusiasm, because obviously they've got everything to lose. They're playing for their playoff lives. And if you're Carmi, I think you can easily sew the Bulldogs to win this game. They've been overlooking Florida.
Other than that opening drive, and really what stalled their opening drive was that penalty. They had a first down conversion called back from a penalty. Other than that opening drive, the Bulldog defense, you know, again, credit a couple bounces. That provides a spark to get them confidence. But you're right, Cole. The Bulldog defense has just not come up and just stymied them or make them earn yards. The Flores has just shown a lot of diversity in their offense. The athlete that Tolliver is, the Propes, the big running back coming around, some of these jet sweeps, the fullback. I mean, they just got a wide array of offense. I mean, one play they're coming at you with jet sweeps and out of the eye. The next play, Tolliver's dropping back to wing at 50 yards. So they just keep you on your toes. You have to honor their receivers. So the Bulldogs have had to go to a four-man front, kind of change their alignment a little bit. Our ends are in a down position instead of standing up. You have to honor Tolliver's athletic ability on the edge, because when you rush him, you have to do what's called contain rush, meaning the ends have to stay real wide, because if you give him a crease, he's got the Parker Price type speed to bust a big play on his own. But so far, you just have to credit Flora for the way they played offensively. And to be in a position tied at halftime against Carmi, and they have all the momentum in the world, it truly is. You know, you've heard me say it a lot of times this year, but I truly believe if the Wolves take this thing and march it down, the Bulldogs are in trouble.
Yeah.
Because we've shown we're not a come-from-behind team. We have got to find a way to get them off the field. A three and out, a four and out, whatever it is. If this Carmi defense can't get Florida off the field this opening series, it's going to be very, very tough sledding, to put it mildly.
A couple of scores from around the region going on in the area. I'm trying to find some BDC scores, but other scores in Southern Illinois region. I do know El Dorado leads Edwards County late in the first half, 40-0. At halftime, Benton leads AJ 21-0. Marion leading, I believe that is now Mattoon, 20-7. Also going on, it is Reeves Modern Day and Mount Zion tied at 21 late in the second quarter. Thought I saw a Johnson City and CZR score. I'm pretty sure it was pretty lopsided on Johnson City's behalf there in the first half, but a lot of teams, if you look at the 2A side, a lot of 4-4 teams that got a win to get in, including Flora, who was tied with Carmi 16-16 here at intermission. But Chris, I mean, on the offensive side of things, Carmi, they took, you know, three drives. You had the one fumble, or actually four drives. You had the one fumble, and then the two touchdown drives, and then the punt there at the end of the first half that didn't result in the punt. It was the bad snap. But I'm not sure if you're too upset with the way the offense played. If I'm Kurt Simon of this coaching staff, I'm just a little concerned about the tiny details, the X's and O's, and the tiny things that has made this Carmine team so good this season that they're lacking on tonight.
Yeah, offensively, you don't have a lot of concerns. You don't have a lot of adjustments to make. It's just a matter of that last drive, not committing a penalty, and, you know, just executing an out route on a pass just a little bit mistimed. Defensively, you've got a lot of concern. If you're Carmine, you have not shown signs of stopping this Wolves team. They've got all, and I mean all, the confidence in the world right now if you're the Florida Wolves. And they're coming out with the ball, a game tied. They don't have to be in a hurry.
No,
they don't. They can take a page out of our book now because, as we saw last week, we're not a come-from-behind team. So if the Wolves take this thing and march it down, you know, Carmine can answer. Yeah, I'm not worried about us answering, but at some point, we're not in a position to trade scores. We just can't. This defense, not only for this game, but just for their confidence, because we will go forward regardless of what happens tonight.
Yeah.
But it's got to be stronger than this. This defense has to make some adjustments, has to rise to the occasion, and just like I said, get their mojo back somehow, because right now, they just look, I mean, our defense just looks
defeated.
Totally discombobulated right now.
Again, halftime score, Carmine 16, Flora 16, here in week 9. Again, the playoff pairings will come out tomorrow night. But, again, if you're Carmine, can't be too concerned about what you're going to see tomorrow night. You've got to come in and take care of business for the rest of this second half. But you're right, Chris, it's going to be very important. If this Flora team can manage a couple of scores here in this third quarter, and the Carmine offense can't rebound and can't answer, I mean, Carmine's, they're going to find themselves in a tough spot. On that same note, though, we've seen a couple of times this year, whether it's the Fairfield game or whatever game it's been this year where Carmine didn't play a great first half. This has been a second half team. I think if you exclude last week, it's been a team where, okay, first half, a little bit of a question mark, but then the second half, they take care of business. But that's what we got to see from Carmine tonight.
Yeah, and still a lot of football to be played. Not to be held doom and gloom, but just being realistic. If the Bulldogs can get it together defensively, they can get control back of this game. But that's really what they're going to have to do. You don't have any, again, your offense is fine. You don't have to make a lot of adjustments, many concerns at all with your offense. It's your defense that is going to have to step up. Whether that's changing your formation a little bit, your scheme, maybe going to more five-man fronts, maybe blitzing a little more, getting some heat back there on Tolliver a little bit. Again, what makes that dangerous? If you're going to blitz him, you better contain him, because if he breaks contain, he has the Parker Price type speed to bust a 50, 60-yard run on you. You know, so that's the thing. I think we're just going to have to make some more aggressive calls defensively and just get a stop. Like I said, if it's not a three and out, let's get a four and out. If we just, for our defense to get some semblance of confidence back, we have to stop them on a series.
We'll put your coaching shoes on and do so radio-friendly, but if you're Coach Simon right now, what are you telling the guys?
What are you telling them heart-wise? Look, you seniors, you have got to step up and start leading the second half. You know, you guys knew that this was going to be a tough game tonight. Yeah, you had the tough loss last week. You had to put it behind it. I don't think they put it behind them. If I'm Kurt Simon, I'm telling them, look, you've got two quarters of football to play. Never mind about next week. That's the last thing. Tonight, for your senior night, your last game on this football field, you're 7-1, and you got a 4-4 football team coming in here, shoving it down your throats and making you look like you don't even want to be here. I mean, that's honestly what I would be saying. And it won't take much for him to motivate him. This group of seniors, I believe they're going to respond. I believe wholeheartedly. Great group of kids. But I think that's the kind of fire and passion and speech you're getting at halftime. Say, look, boys, this is your senior night. This is your field. You got two quarters. Let's come out here and turn this thing around.
And he has said numerous times talking to him this year that this is a senior group that he doesn't have to motivate, and I can imagine these guys are going to make themselves motivated for the second half. We'll step aside for a two-minute break. Third quarter coming up here in just a bit right here on 97.3 WRUL.
show is produced courtesy of the Jordan Funeral Group, remembering lives well lived and honoring tradition of Bulldog Athletics. Visit jordanfuneralgroup.com for more information. Again, halftime, your score, the Bulldogs 16, Flora 16, here in week 9 of the 2022 high school football season. Okay, tomorrow morning we'll have the Saturday morning sports show live on 97.3 WRUL and 93.3 WROI. Chris and I will recap tonight's contest and look around at the other scores going on in Southern Illinois with the final week of playoffs, also an in or final week of the regular season, I should say. Also, playoffs getting underway over to our neighbors in Indiana. So we'll recap all those scores and look ahead to also regionals beginning for volleyball on Tuesday. They will play the winner of, I believe it's Mount Carmel in Harrisburg. They are the 2 seed in Mount Carmel. So they'll play the winner of those two games on Tuesday. If they win that, they will play the winner of Hamilton County versus El Dorado and Benton on Thursday for a potential regional championship. So best of luck to Chris Lucas and his Lady Bulldogs next week as they begin their postseason play.
Got to see them in the week up in Grayville. Win. So absolutely good luck to the volleyball Lady Bulldogs, and hopefully they can make a deep postseason run too.
Again, won their first regional in 44 years last season. Hopefully they can do the same again this fall. They're going to have to beat a couple of good teams. I know Hamilton County has got a pretty good team this year. They are the 1 seed in that regional, so they'll have to get the best of them. If they get past their first contest, again, they play on Tuesday. If they win, they will play on Thursday. So the Bulldogs will kick off to start the second half. Flora will get the ball, and I got a feeling we're going to have a pretty good idea of how this rest of the game is going to go on this first drive.
Well, it is gut check time.
Absolutely. No question.
If we were receiving, you might have a little better feeling, but we just got to get it done.
So Brayton Stockton will kick this one away. Low line drive, wobbly kick is going to be downed at the Flora 26-yard line. So first and 10 for the Wolves from that spot. And so Carmi got the ball to start the ball game back in the first quarter. They fumbled. Flora would punt. Bulldogs would score, Wolves would score, Bulldogs would score, Wolves would score. Both teams got their two-point conversions, and here we are.
It's a battle. We said this team is another. Don't sleep on this team. And looks like, unfortunately, Gavin Payton coming out without shoulder pads on. Don't know what his injury is, but it's like we've lost him for the second half, starting defensive tackle.
Tolliver in the shotgun here on first down and 10. Handoff up the middle. I believe that's McGee, the ball carrier. Actually, it's that time it was number 36, Popes again.
Great play. Number 22, Trayton Vickers. I'll tell you what, it looks like Popes is going to bounce that and bust it for long yardage. Vickers, a nice job stopping him at the line of scrimmage. Good way to start for Carmi. We'll see if we get two more of these.
So no gain on the play. So second down and 10, 4-4 from their own 27-yard line. Tolliver in the shotgun. Again, nobody out wide here for Flora. Going with kind of a tight set. Popes behind Tolliver in the shotgun. Tolliver back to pass. He's got time. That pocket collapses, but he's able to roll out of it. And Tolliver is going to pick up a first down across the 35-yard line. And again, you see the athletic ability by Malachi Tolliver. The pocket collapsed. He was able to escape and get a first down.
That's the danger he presents. Bryson Moore had a hand on him. And most other quarterbacks, they're going down once Bryson Moore gets their hands on him. But Tolliver just showed you what a quick burst, what an athlete he is. Turned a sack into a first down just like that. So Bulldogs with good coverage, good pressure. It just, Tolliver is an athlete.
First and 10 for Flora from the 130-yard line. Tolliver in the shotgun. One wide receiver on each side. Popes behind him in the shotgun. Tolliver. A little bit of miscommunication, and they give it off to McGee, and he's got nowhere to go. Might have been some miscommunication on the handoff that time for Flora. It was actually 19 O'Donnell who got the carry. The Bulldogs tackle him for a loss of two. So that's back-to-back times on this drive. The Bulldogs get a loss on first down.
Couldn't tell if he was maybe wanting to take that more off the edge or whatever, but that stutter step cost him the loss of yardage. So second and long here again.
Wolfson, the receiver each side. Second down and 12. Tolliver will toss it on the right side. It's Probst, the ball carrier, and this time he's drugged down in the backfield for another loss. Bryson Moore got to him, and it brings up third and 15 here for the Wolves.
Bryson Moore with a monster play. That play had just absolutely gashed us in the first half. We just didn't have an answer for it. That time Bryson Moore got off the block. A play that had just, we hadn't been able to stop it. Like I said, the first half, Moore showed his athletic ability, stopped Probst from behind. Now you got to watch Tolliver here. You've got to have a good balance.
Third and 15, Tolliver back to pass, looking now, rolls out to his right, pressure in his face, throws wide open, and a four first down inside the 45, and tackled inside the 40 was O'Donnell. And the Wolves move the chains on third and long. Wide open.
And Carmi that time is honoring Tolliver's ability to run, so we're not blitzing. That means your corners and your safeties are one-on-one back there. And the more time Tolliver's given, the more time you have for your receivers to get open. And that time the receiver just kind of ran a little underneath route. It was wide open, got underneath the defense.
First and 10 for Flora from the Carmi 37-yard line. 16-16 the score with 9 minutes to go in the third quarter. Tolliver in the shotgun. Probst behind him. Move a man in motion. Now it's Tolliver on the quarterback run up the middle, and he's got nowhere to go. Bryson Moore got to him. Right past the line of scrimmage, maybe got a yard.
And Bryson Moore single-handedly saying this beginning of the second half,
yep.
Hey, if I got to put you on my shoulders and carry us, I will. So he's made some big plays. A little second and short there, but again, this Tolliver has just shown what a dangerous player he is. Kind of begs the question of, you know, how is Flora 4-4?
Yeah.
You know, really, I mean,
beat El Dorado, beat CZR, beat Edwards County, and then lost to Hamilton County. Handoff on the jet sweep, and there's Bryson Moore again shooting through.
Yes, sir.
Big tackle on the backfield.
I said it. He's decided. I'm a senior. If he was in that locker room and they got the speech, this is my last two quarters of football in regular season on this field, I'm making the most of it. He's doing it.
They'll give him four in progress and put the football at the Carmi 40. So that might be the play to spark this Bulldog defense just a little bit.
But again, you've got to find a way to stop Tolliver. I'd say this time, yeah, if I'm them, I might try to bring some pressure up the middle. Nelson Ryder back there, the lone middle backer, maybe bring some heat on him.
Third and 13 from the Carmi 40. Tolliver back to pass. He's got time. Now he rolls out to his right. Tolliver met by Moore. He's able to get away from Ryder. And Tolliver's going to take off and get the first down inside the Carmi 25.
Goodness. Goodness gracious. Is he something?
Malachi Tolliver broke a sack from Bryson Moore. Nelson Ryder also had him in the backfield. Able to get out of it and pick up 14 when he needed 13. First down floor to the Carmi 24.
How many times can I say it?
Ugh.
He is single-handedly willing his way to make the possible out of the impossible. Bryson Moore had him dead to rights, and he just broke that. What an athlete.
Tolliver on the shotgun here on first and 10 from the Carmi 24. Tolliver turns, give it off to McGee off the left side, and he'll run right into the Bulldog defensive line. Little to no gain there, second down. But I'm right there with you, Chris. You really wonder, you know, did Flora really change things up that much for this game tonight against Carmi? Because this does not look like a team that, you know, lost to Hamilton County earlier in the year.
No.
They lost to Cesar by two scores last week. They've lost to Fairfield and Johnson City, of course, but they look good tonight.
Yeah.
You can't deny that.
We just are having a tough time dealing with him. He's a big athletic kid, and we just can't get him tackled.
Second down and 7 from the Carmi 21-yard line. They've taken 6 minutes off the clock here in the third quarter. Tolliver throws to the right side, caught on the sideline, running down the sideline and taking it inside the 10-yard line. For a Flora first down, that was Patridge, and it's first and goal for the Wolves.
Again, man-to-man coverage out there in the flats. The safeties have to play deep, and so it's just a 10-yard out route, and it's wide open against this coverage. Bulls have just converted on big plays. Third and longs twice tonight. They've just answered the bell, and this crowd is in stunned silence.
First and goal from the 3-yard line for Flora. A tie ball game, 6:12 to go in the third. Tolliver under center, gives it off to Propes. Left side, and Propes is into the end zone. Touchdown, Flora. And the Wolves have the lead with 6:07 to go in the third quarter.
And just when you thought we had him stopped on third and long, Tolliver, again, I've said his name over and over, he has just been absolute magic tonight for Flora. We've had no answer for him. So now, this conversion could put our backs against the wall.
Well, and how about Flora's ability to kill clock? They took 6 minutes of clock off that quarter.
Yeah.
So they'll go for two. This could be big. 22-16 the score. Under center is Tolliver. They toss it right side to Propes. He'll turn up field and get in. Flora is 3-for-3 on two-point plays, and they lead it by 8, 24-16, with 6:07 to go in the third quarter. We'll take a 30-second break right here on 97.3 WRUF. And 6 minutes of time off the clock to take a 24-16 lead over Carmel White County. Again, the Bulldogs 7-1, Flora 4-4, trying to fight for their chance to stay in the playoff hunt. And the kickoff will go into the end zone as Keen Allen lets it go past him. Carmel will take this ball at their own 20.
Well, there's still 6:07. It's just the third quarter. Carmel can just do what they do, you know, but
It comes down to the defense.
It's going to be the defense. In this game, if we can come and tie this thing, I think this game honestly is going to come down to who gets the ball last.
It very well could.
And if we can't get a stop, there's nothing we're going to be able to do. At some point, we've got to find a way to get them off the field.
We had him. They just seem flat.
Yeah. Defensively, we are just on our heels.
Under center is Legg here on first down and 10. They give it off to King on the right side, and Isaac will take it across the 20. Not much running room. Got about 4 yards up to the 24. So second down and 6 here for Carmine. On this possession at their own 24-yard line. Again, 24-16, Flora with the lead, 5:35 to play in the third quarter. Legg under center. They go to a double wingback set here, Carmine is. They go toss left side to Odd. Odd trying to bounce it. He can't. Got maybe 2 yards, third down. Carmine went with a Fairfield set there.
Yeah.
Went tight.
Never seen
this. Nobody in the backfield, and right about 2 yards.
First time I'd seen that all year.
They wouldn't put Eli Bryant in there at right guard.
Yeah.
They kind of move things around on the offensive line.
Yeah, Gavin Payton out with an injury. Not sure what it is, so we've shuffled things a little bit.
So third down and 3. Call it probably 4 for Carmine from the own 27. Under center is Legg. They toss it right side to King, trying to turn up field, and the Wolves defense is going to stop Carmine. And here comes the Bulldog punt team.
And I'm just surprised we went to that. You know, I thought our tee and wing and most of our base offense was productive. But.
And Flores is just getting a lot of penetration up front.
Yeah.
Carmine's having a hard time of getting a push.
I'm surprised we're punting this, to be honest.
It was a bad snap last time. This one gets to Gomat, and it's a high punt, not a far punt. It's on the Carmi sideline. It will take a Carmi bounce and a Carmi roll, and it will be downed at the floor, 42-yard line. So good field position for the Wolves, who lead by 8 with 4:02 to play in the third quarter, 24-16. And now, Chris, there's no question, you've got to get a stop if you're Carmi's defense.
Yeah. Quite honestly, if the Wolves put together another one of these long drives, it could be curtains.
But the way they were able to kill someone, I mean, they had the ball for 6 minutes. Carmi had it for 2 minutes and 5 seconds.
Yeah.
If you're Carmi, you just, it's...
And I'm just kind of a little shell-shocked, too.
Three outs tonight.
Yeah, by our, well, going to the double wing. I just, it kind of surprised me, but... Got to play some defense.
First and 10 for Flora from their own 42-yard line. Tolliver hands it off on the right side. O'Donnell trying to turn up field, and there's not much running room for him. Got maybe a yard back to the 42. Well, until Carmi is getting a little bit better on those first and second down runs, but again, it was twice in the last drive. Third and long, Flora converts. You got to go out the field.
Yeah, it's just when Tolliver drops back to pass. That's their greatest weapon. That double wing set for them out of the eye. When he drops back, the ball in his hands is their weapon, period. Whether he's going to throw it or whether he's going to run it, if I'm them, I just stay in that formation, put the ball in his hands, give him the option.
Second and 9, ball at the 4, 43-yard line. And the shotgun is Tolliver, and they move a man in motion. Tolliver waiting, they have to burn a timeout. Some miscommunication there on the play call for Flora. I think he wanted O'Donnell to go in motion and go in the backfield. And O'Donnell had to stay there and jog in place, so there wasn't a penalty, and the Wolves brought a timeout. So with 3:13 to go to the third quarter, we'll take a timeout as well. Back in 30 seconds. With the football and an 8-point lead, 28-16. Cole Carter and Chris Myers. A lot of stunned silence on the Carmi sideline. Can Flora 4-4, Carmi 7-1. And the Wolves face 2nd-9. Tolliver in the shotgun. And move O'Donnell in motion to get it off to Probst up the middle, and Probst will get stuck at the 35. They'll bring up 3rd-6. So again, not sure if it's 4-down territory. Call it 3rd-7, but man, Chris, for the Bulldog defense, you've got to get off the field on this play.
You just want to get them the 4th down here. And I don't know, Cole, I'm not so sure they don't go for it on 4th down. You know, their best weapon is just the ball in Tolliver's hands. That's their best weapon. So we'll see what they do here. If we can force a 4th down here, it'll be interesting, but we've got to do that first.
3rd-7. 2.5 to play in the third quarter, 24-16. Tolliver on the shotgun. He takes the snap. He's back to pass. Pressure up the middle. He rolls out to his right. Passes. Dropped.
Fortunately.
Oh, he would have had a 1st down. It was O'Donnell who had it right at the chains, and it went off his hands. A quick out route, and it's 4th down, and we'll see what Flora wants to do.
Same play they've been running all night. Yeah, our safeties are having to stay so far back to honor that wide out. They're just taking the wing, running that little 7-8 yard out, and it's wide open. Fortunately, a drop there. And even that's not Tolliver punting, is it?
I believe it is.
So you got to watch that. We got no one covering. There we go. We had to burn a timeout.
Carmi's got to burn a timeout because there was nobody covering the gunner on the left side. And
that makes you wonder, is Florida going to rethink things?
In a game that you don't want to burn timeouts, that one doesn't help.
No.
With 2:23 to go in the third quarter. 24-16, Florida with the lead. Take a second and try to find some other scores from around the area. Sure, a lot of games are in the second half already.
Let's see. Carterville all over Harrisburg at halftime about half an hour ago, 42-7. It was Johnson City over CZR, 49-0 at halftime. That's about all I can see right now.
And here we go. Keep your eye on Tolliver.
So, Wolves are in the punt formation here on fourth down and 7 from their own 45-yard line. And they will punt it. Tolliver gets it away. It's a good punt. Driscoll fields it from the 20-yard line, now running near side. Driscoll looking for blockers. Not much there. And he gets it across the 25 to the 27. So first and 10 for Carmi. And
we got to stop.
Yeah, I got to stop.
We
got to score.
Yeah,
got to score. And again, I mean, Chris, I think more than anything, obviously Carmi has not played their best game of the year, but you really got to tip your cap to four.
Yes.
And the way that they have come out and played. They've done a lot of X's and O's changes in terms of to prepare for this Carmi team, and it's paid off.
It definitely has. They have used their best player to their full advantage. Tolliver, back to the quarterback position, is a dual threat, and give them credit. They've made critical plays, but now it's up to the Bulldogs.
First and 10. They toss to King on the left side. King's trying to bounce it across the 25-yard line, and he's taken down. They're across the 35-yard line, up just shy of the 40 to about the 39. Gain of 8 there for Isaac on first down.
And like to see that back in our traditional formations. Hit the edge. They're still stacking the box. Plenty of time if you're Carmi. Don't have to panic by any means, but obviously we do have to score.
Second down and 2. 1:45 to play. In the third quarter, 24-16, Carmi has the ball down by 8 at their own 38-yard line. Gregg under center in the T formation. They give it off to Odd left side. Odd is going to get a first down up across the 40 to about the 43-yard line. That's a rush appliance first down.
And then that'll stop the clock. 1:31 left in the third. Plenty of time for the Bulldogs to answer, but in the fourth quarter, again, us not being a quick strike team, we're going to have to play defense again.
80 seconds left to play in the third quarter. That two-point conversion to the floor got on that touchdown drive. Really leans large here. First and 10 from the 43. Leg will toss to off the right side, and Otto's tripped up just across the 45. It seems like every time Carmi has tried to use the backfield to get upfield, Floor's been there.
Their linebackers are just doing a good job penetrating the gaps. That time, the inside backer just kind of shot the B gap. Drax was going to try to keep going the outside, but that blitz kind of forced him back in. So, yeah, they've done a good job containing that little quick pitch play that we run.
Down to 35 seconds left to go in the third quarter, 24-16. Floor with the lead. Carmi in the power eye formation. Leg gives it off to King up the middle, and Isaac's just got nowhere to go.
Wow.
So much penetration at the line of scrimmage. He was able to still get about 3 yards, but it brings up third and 5 for Carmi at the 49-yard line.
9 men in the box. It's just going to be tough sledding. Floor knows what's coming in those power eye and T formations. They're stacking the box. Again, you have to be able to kind of hit that edge crease there. But this is, I would say this is two down territory for the Bulldogs.
We go to the fourth quarter of play. Your score, Flora 24, Carmi White County 16. We'll take a 1 minute break right here on 97.3 WRUL. Back here in Carmi, start of the fourth quarter, Cole Carter and Chris Myers. Flora leads the Bulldogs. I'm not mistaken, they lead the Bulldogs.
Yeah.
24-16 as we start the fourth and final quarter here in the regular season. 24-16, and Chris, I don't think anybody in Southern Illinois outside of Florida expected this.
No, nobody. I mean, this crowd's shocked, we're shocked, and this Bulldog team is shocked.
Here we go, third down and five for Carmi from their own 49. Greg under center.
That's all nice. Yep.
They tried to get Florida jump off sides, but Carmi jumped first. False start, back it up 5 yards. Now a third and five, goes to a third and 10.
And that's been this game in a microcosm. A play that's normally there for us, that old hard count, linemen go down, get them to jump. This time we're the ones. And that's, you know, when a play you relied on to be a good trick play for you all season, all of a sudden it's backfiring on you, you know things aren't going your way. And now if we don't get this, I think we are forced to punt this ball, Cole.
Third down and nine. Florida is stacking that box defensively. From their own 44-yard line, they'll toss it left side to King. He's got to change directions, and he can't get away from the Florida defensive line. Tackled in the backfield, and Carmi will punt.
They had that bunch formation. We're going to try to run a sweep. I thought Isaac was going to go ahead and just keep fighting to the outside. He tried to make a cut the last second, and the Florida defensive end was just all over it. If he maybe could have kept to the outside, he would have had something. But again, it's easier to see up here than it is down there. So
Carmi forced to punt here at their own 35-yard line. These have been all but routine tonight. Tyler Gomet back to punt. Good snap and a high punt again. And this is going to take a hop at the 40-yard line, and it will roll and be down at the 4:36. So first and 10 for the Wolves from that spot. And again, the Carmi defense, you are in a must-stop case scenario. A score by four might put this game away.
Yeah. Normally with 11:07 left in a ball game, you know, you're thinking, okay, that's plenty of time. Get a three and out. With the Bulldog team, that's not a quick strike team. 11:07 is not a lot of time. So it's up to our defense. Game by no means is over. It's just we have got to dig deep and make a play. Both sides of the ball now.
First and 10 for Flora from their own 36-yard line. Tolliver back to pass. Quarterback run up the middle. And Tolliver will be stood up at the 40. Although Nelson Riley was the first one that got to him at the 39-yard line.
And that was a designed quarterback draw.
Mm-hmm.
That time Tolliver just up the middle. About a 5-yard gain on that one, 4 yards, but good play design. Remember when I'd said at half, you're not concerned about your offense, and now all of a sudden, whatever was ailing our defense just spilled over into our offense. And
well, there's no question that Flores is winning the battle up front.
No, it just turned so suddenly. This Wolves team is just playing on fire.
Second and six. Tolliver in the shotgun. He's back to pass here on second down. They run the screen. King deflected it. Ball in the air. It's going to be caught by Tolliver. That helps Carmi.
Yeah.
Man, if Isaac could have somehow picked that one off, it would have been an easy touchdown.
Tolliver did us a favor. You're right.
Hey, Carmi caught a break, though, because they had a perfect screen play.
Yes.
He was open.
Yes.
King got a hand on it. Such a big play. Now it's third down at about 20 with four with the football back at their own 27.
Yeah.
And again, Chris, you got to get the field here.
You do. And Tolliver's proven that third and forever is nothing for him.
If you let a big chunk here,
yeah,
and let it get fourth and manageable.
And we got two safeties back, so watch that out route.
Tolliver in the shotgun here on third down and 19. Back to pass. Tolliver with time. Throws one to the near sideline. That's into the Carmi bench. It's fourth down. And I assume Flora will punt.
Yes.
And they will on fourth and 19. Carmi able to get the stop.
Monstrous, monstrous stop there. Isaac King, honestly, he
played the game so far.
Saved. That could have been a touchdown on the screen pass because there was nothing but real estate if he completes that pass. And then consequently, Tolliver did us a favor by catching it and taking a huge loss. So now the Bulldogs have to answer the bell here. Got to tie this game up.
Tolliver will punt this one away, and a good punt of that. Driscoll calls the fair catch and makes the catch
at the Carmi 28-yard line. So that Bulldogs will start the drive from that spot.
And that was a monstrous catch by Driscoll because he signaled a fair catch. He made that over his head, over his shoulder. I mean, he didn't make that catch. That ball rolls. We could have had the ball a lot worse field position.
He's had some trouble fielding punts cleanly so far this season. Muff won a couple of weeks ago against El Dorado, but he hangs on to that one. And so it's first and 10 for Carmi from the 29-yard line.
And I think we're finally at a point, Cole, where we may have to mix in some pass here.
Only one pass attempt so far. It was incomplete in the direction of Kate Allen back in the second quarter. First and 10 for Carmi from their own 29. Under center his leg. The move dots in a motion. Counter. Handoff right side to King. Nowhere to go. I mean, just nowhere to go. Flora is penetrating that defensive front, and King a little slow to get up.
Yeah. And that was the defensive end that time. I think that's number 60, Gabe Ivanko. 220-pounder just absolutely blew that up. We tried to pull the left guard, Connor Buchanan, for a kick out, and he just ate it alive.
Flora leads 24-16, and a 9 to go in this one. Leg under center. In the power eye formation, takes the snap, give it off to King up the middle, and King again, nowhere to go. I mean, Flora is stacking all 11 guys and blitzing about 9 of them, and Carmi just can't get anything.
No, they've just all out committed to it. And if there's no threat of any type of play action pass or no threat of any variation,
why not? Why not?
Just leave 11 guys out there. Just leave them.
Gotta wonder if you're Carmi, you gotta try to switch things up here.
Yeah, and if you do put the ball in the air and don't get it, at least you stop the clock.
With a wing back to the left side, under center his leg on 3rd and 9. The move out in motion. They fake the toss to Odd. Now back to pass his leg. He throws one down the field. King is open. He got it. Isaac King to the end zone. Touchdown, Carmi.
Right on cue. Breathing room, putting the ball in the air, beautifully executed play-action pass. They fake that inside toss counter. King, wide open, went, got behind the linebacker, snuck to the line. Beautifully executed, perfectly timed.
And
possibly
a great throw by one.
Great throw by leg, all kinds of time, great job by the line. Now if we can get this conversion, let's hope that's going to change some momentum here. But that's what the Bulldogs had to do.
Yeah.
They had to show the ability at some point to throw the ball.
Because, again, if you stay one-dimensional, it makes them that much easier for the Bears.
They're waiting on it. They're just keeping 11 guys there.
This could be the play of the game.
Let's see what we get.
Two-point conversion in a two-point game. Under center his leg. He takes the snap. They give it off to King. On the right side, and we are tied at 24. It's 7:58 to play. The Bulldogs aren't dead yet. And they got to get a step on defense. 24-24 with 7:58 to play in the ballgame. We'll take a 30-second break right here on 97.3 WRUL. Leg to Isaac King. King runs in the two-point conversion, and just like that, we're tied at 24 with 8 minutes to go.
Potentially season-saving score.
Stockton will line this kick. Bounces off a Fuller player. It's a live football. Carmi might have it.
No.
And the officials quickly say the Wolves were able to recover it.
Boy, that was close. That would have been, that would have been almost too good to be true.
But here we go, Chris. I mean, the Carmi defense has gotten a couple of big stops.
Yeah.
The offense. Big play by King on the screen pass really helped. But now you have to get a stop with 8 minutes to go.
Your offense has gotten the spark it needed. That big play action pass and what the Bulldogs had to do. Eventually, they were going to have to throw the football, and they finally did it. Gave us the spark we need. Now the defense
has to rise to this occasion. Keep this momentum going.
And now the crowd comes alive here on first down and 10. Tolliver in the shotgun. They move a man in motion. They give it off up the middle. This is McGee trying to bounce it. And McGee is going to plow his way up to around the 40. About a 5-yard pickup on first down. Second and 5 coming up.
That was a nice run by McGee. Made a good cutback. Looked like, not to nitpick, I saw a little bit of holding at the top there by the left side of the four offensive line. But
it's been a relatively clean game in terms of flags. There's been a couple of flags thrown after the play against four, but for the most part, a clean game on both sides.
Yeah. The Bulldogs, you want to stop. You got to get the ball back. And the Wolves, with the game tied, they're not in a hurry. They don't want to give the ball back to Carmi right now, so they're taking their time.
Second down and 5. Tolliver in the shotgun. They move a man in motion. Tolliver takes the snap. They give it off to Probst, the ball carrier, and Probst got stuffed initially but was able to plow forward for an extra yard or two to bring up third down, about 3 for the Wolves at their own 44.
Right. Probst, he is a hard runner.
Yeah.
Stocky, he's kind of a bit like Drax Odd, almost identical. 5'9", 180. He keeps his legs turning. Now to Carmi, 3rd and 2. Big play here for both teams.
Could be 4-down territory for Flora. Under center is Stolliver with 6.5 to play. Hand it off to Probst up the middle.
He got it.
And he's going to have enough for a first down to move the chains up to the 47-yard line.
They're just taking a page out of our book when it comes to running the ball this half. You know, first half, those plays were no gains. And now they're just, the Probst is just running the ball so hard. Just determined every carry. And that sometimes it's just something that's the difference. It's not the scheme. It's just that second effort.
6:18 to play in the ball game. We're tied at 24. Tolliver under center. Two receivers out wide to the right and one to the left. And Tolliver has taken plenty of time in between snaps. Under center, they move a man in motion. That's O'Donnell. Now they toss it to that side. It's Probst, the ball carrier, trying to get the edge, and he can't. Slung down out of bounds by Tyler Gomack. Got about 2 yards.
Nice play by Gomack coming over and getting him out of bounds.
They call it a gain of 3 there for Probst. The clock continues to run under 6 minutes to play.
Both teams with 2 timeouts left. And then again, Flora doesn't have to be in a hurry to snap the ball at any time. They are going to take every second they can get. And you can see them. They're in no hurry to snap it.
And the shotgun is Tolliver. Play clock down to 10. Game clock down to 3:38. 5:38, I'm sorry. And the shotgun, Tolliver takes the snap. They fake the handoff. Now Tolliver runs left side. Tolliver is going to be near the first down marker, and I think he's got it.
He does. Just a little quarterback counter. Fake the fullback. Tolliver just becomes a weapon off that left side. Just a quarterback counter. Design run. The snap looked a little low. I thought for a second that snap almost hit the ground, but now the clock is definitely on the side of Flora, and they're driving.
5:20 left to play. Tolliver in the shotgun, one wide receiver at each side, a tight end off the ball on the left, and a running back to the left of Tolliver. He takes the snap. They give it off to O'Donnell on the second man through. O'Donnell will take one to the sideline where he's tackled at the 35 of Carmi.
And they're just doing a good job of just consistently just plowing this ball ahead at us. That time O'Donnell on a similar type play. Just an kind of a dive off the left side out of the eye. They're just gashing this Bulldog front. And it's setting up perfect for Flora. Now with 4:30 left in the game, you're in Bulldog territory, 2 timeouts left. Carmi needs an answer.
Tolliver in the shotgun on second down. Tolliver takes the snap. They give it off to Pope's on the right side. He's tripped up. Chase Pringle as well as Caleb Seavers with the tackle. And it brings up 3rd and 4. A big 3rd and 4 here as we approach the 4-minute mark here in the ballgame, 24-24.
Huge play there. Looks like Seavers just blitzed off the edge. I think the Bulldogs, you know, maybe just need to sell out and try a run blitz here. They're in 4-down territory.
Flora hurt themselves earlier in the quarter on a pass play.
Immediate conversion here on third down.
Lots for Tolliver here.
Third and three. Tolliver in the shotgun. They move O'Donnell in motion. They give it off to O'Donnell. He tries to bounce it. He's trying to get away from King. He goes to the inside. Tripped up. And does he have enough for a first down?
Mm.
He only had to get 3 yards. They marked the football at the Carmi 33.
Am I going to show him maybe an inch short, like a few inches, but Odd and King were there. Oh, they get in the first.
They won't measure.
Odd and King were there. He just made a good cut. Yep. Went back to the inside.
Now 3:19 to go. And the clock will run whenever they get the chain set.
And remember, Florida can put the ball in the end zone.
Yep.
They have their throwing capability, as we've seen tonight.
We haven't seen Florida kick it. Not sure if they can kick it if they get to that spot. 3:05 to play. Florida has the ball in a tie game at the Carmi 32-yard line. Tolliver in the shotgun. One wide receiver on each side. Tolliver letting that clock tick down. Under 3 minutes to play. Puts a man in motion. They give it off to the second man through. That's McDonald. And O'Donnell, I should say, will get tackled before progress. The correction, that was McGee at the 30-yard line. About a 4-yard pickup.
And I think Florida just may be trying to work this clock down to do one of two things, to take a shot at the end zone at some point, or, you know, I'm with you, Cole. I didn't have a chance to check out their kicking game. Don't know if they have an extra-point kicker. They haven't kicked
tonight.
You don't
want to give Carmi any time.
No. And they may just in another way, we're content to play for overtime because we haven't shown the ability to stop them 10-yard increments.
Second down and 8. And the shotgun is Tolliver. They move a man in motion. They give it off to Popes up the middle, and Popes is going to be stuffed. And here comes 3rd down and 5.
And if you're Carmi, do you think about using the timeout if you stop them this next play?
I think you do. I think you do. Because, again, if you don't get a stop here, you're probably not getting the ball in regulation.
No. Floor may be thinking that. They may
and
be
if you're Carmi, if you get this ball here, if you get the stop, get the chance of this game going to overtime pretty high.
Yeah.
100 seconds left to play. 24-24. 3rd down and 6 for Flora at the Carmi 28-yard line. Tolliver still letting that clock tick down. He's in the shotgun. He takes the snap. He's going to run to his left. He's got blockers in front. He's trying to find the edge. He's got the edge, and he's down the sideline and taken down out of bounds inside the Carmi 15.
And they may have been setting that up. You knew at some point they were going to call his number and have him give him a big play, and he did just that. Our defensive ends just absolutely jumped inside, got washed down by the wing. Receivers running our corners downfield. It was set up perfectly. No one there. That was a gimme first down.
80 seconds left to play. Flora has the football at the Carmi 14. We're tied at 24. And the shotgun is Tolliver. Tolliver moves a man in motion. He'll take the snap. Quarterback run up the middle. Tries to change directions. Breaks a couple of tackles. Now spins away. Gets it inside the 10. And he's down to around the 6. They're going to say he's inside the 5. And that should be enough for a first down. It's going to be first and goal for Flora with 72 seconds left to play.
And if you're Flora, you don't have to do anything. The Bulldogs can't use their timeouts now.
And the Bulldogs will use a timeout to stop the clock with 1:12 to play.
Yeah.
Bulldogs only have one left. Flores got the football at the Carmi 4-yard line. It's not a first down. It's second down and a yard. But Carmi calls a timeout. Wow.
Just everybody shell-shocked. But you got to do nothing but credit the Florida Wolves.
Absolutely.
They've wanted this game more. They've had a great scheme. Their best player has put them on their back and carried them. And that's what had to happen for them. The Bulldogs have just not answered the bell defensively tonight. Like I said, it took a couple small breaks to spark the Florida offense. A couple bounces could have been 4 and out or 3 and out for us. We have the ball and we're on our way, but it didn't work that way tonight. And credit the Wolves. They took those sparks and turned it into an absolute forest fire.
They're measuring to see if Flora has enough for the first down on that previous run play.
And it's a little short, they're indicating.
They're going to say second and about a yard. 1:12 left to play. The ball's at the Carmi 4-yard line. Flora is 4 yards away from possibly extending their season another week. Second down and a half a yard at the Carmi 4-yard line after the Carmi timeout. Quarterback Tolliver is in the shotgun. Down doesn't really matter here if you're Flora. Just want to get the ball in the end zone. 1:12 to play.
If you're the Bulldogs, you're trying to strip the football. Do whatever you can to create a turnover.
Tolliver in the shotgun. He moves a man in motion. Tolliver takes a snap, trying to run, goes left, and he is going to be stopped short of the end zone. He's got the first down, but he's not in the end zone. He's in the 2-yard line. And the clock will continue to run once they move the chains.
Oh, looks like they stopped it.
They'll stop it for now, but once they get the chain in place, they'll start it up.
Yep. And the Bulldogs, with only one timeout, little they can do to stop the clock now.
First and goal from the 3-yard line. Tied at 24, under a minute to go, and the clock ticking. And the shotgun is Tolliver. Moves the man in motion, takes the snap. They give it off to Popes, going on the edge. Popes has got blockers, and Popes has got the end zone. No, did he fumble it?
They must have lost possession, but he hit the pylon.
Could the rolling be?
I don't know if he said he lost control.
They're going to say he's out of bounds at the one.
Wow.
They're going to say he's out of bounds at the one with 38.4 seconds.
Still not a whole lot of consequence to Flora, but.
Again, Flora has two timeouts. You got to get half a yard. Ball right outside the goal line.
If Probst is under center, you probably look for a sneak here. Tolliver.
Under center is Tolliver. Quarterback sneak, touchdown Flora. With 35 seconds to play, the Wolves have the lead. 30-24.
And the stunned silence is deafening here in Carmi. There's nothing you can say, but you have to give credit to the Flora Wolves. They have just executed a fantastic game plan this whole night. A couple of tip passes that went their way sparked this offense, and they never looked back. And it just seemed like the Bulldog defense never recovered mentally from last week at Johnson City. It carried over to this week, and this was the ultimate trap game.
Flora will go for two. Tolliver will toss it to Probst, and Probst is not going to get in there. So that's a little bit of a positivity note for Carmi. There were 35 seconds left to play. Flora has a 6-point lead. So Chris, obviously all hope is not lost. You still got time. You got a timeout. But with the way that Carmi's offense works, you've got to imagine there's not many plays that you can design to get 6 points in 35 seconds.
We're not a spread team. We're not a two-minute drill team. So the best you can hope for, and I don't know, Flora will probably squib kick this thing so they don't allow a big return. I don't think they'd, the only danger is you kick this thing deep to King.
He could break it.
Yeah. I don't think they're going to kick. I wouldn't think they'd kick it to him if they're thinking field position. But, if we get the ball with roughly 30 seconds left and one timeout, there's not a 70-yard pass play you got in your arsenal. So.
King and Allen are deep for the Bulldogs. Back at their own 15-yard line. It's going to be a line drive kick on the ground, and Vickers falls to a knee to catch it. About 5 milliseconds comes off the clock. Probably would have liked Vickers to pick that up and try to get positive yards there. But so it's first and 10 for Carmi at their own 29-yard line.
And if you're the Wolves, all you got to do is keep a wall of defenders about 30 yards back. You can anybody blitz, put pressure, blitz, and you'll have yourself an upset victory. Remember, saw this coming a mile away, Cole.
And out of all the teams on the schedule, I mean, Florida,
the least.
Yeah. First and 10 for Carmi, and a timeout's going to be taken by Flora with 34.2 seconds left. That really helps Flora. The play helps Carmi. The play clock was winding down, so.
Mm-hmm. And your player, they're probably going to have to call that same play action pass they did last time. But again, I think the Wolves are going to talk it over and just. I think you just got to keep your defenders.
Yeah. If I'm Flora, I'm just sending three or four guys down to the goal line.
I'm putting them back to the 20.
You know, it's the old, you know, mind miracle. You don't want to send Gronk down there, but you got to send somebody down there that can make a tackle. But
we don't have, like I said, there's not a 70-yard pass play in the air that we have. So you just keep the disastrous from happening for Flora.
So after the timeout, it'll be first and 10 for Carmi from their own 28, 34.4 seconds on the clock. Flora leads 30-24.
And you're right, folks. Flora leads 30-24.
Who would have saw this coming?
With the ease, the Bulldogs are moving the ball, and open drive. We just thought it was going to be a normal night, and it wasn't.
And the Bulldogs drop some kind of trick play here on first and 10 from their own 28. Back to pass goes Leg. He's going to roll out to his left. Now he rolls back to his right. Warren can't take a sack here, and he's going to be tackled across the 40-yard line. Did he get a first down? That will stop the clock.
They're going to get right on the ball.
Let them spike it. Yeah, Chris Simon saying get on the ball. So as soon as they set this ball and start the clock, Warren can spike it, and they do start the clock, and Warren does spike it with 22.4 seconds. Well, a good job by Warren to not take a sack or take a tackle for a loss there either way. Had to get a first down to stop the clock. That's what they did, but still, 22 seconds, not much time, and man, really got to think, no Mitchell Edwards tonight either, and we know he's got the capability of throwing the ball 60 yards. And
your deep ball threat throwing the ball is out.
Yeah.
I know Driscoll just went in, so.
We're going to see some sort of spread that we saw at the end of the game last week.
Get a little more speed downfield, so.
And if you're Carmine, you got to target the sideline here. You know, only one timeout. The first down will stop the clock enough to let you spike it.
Let's see what we're coming out in. Power eye, so it's going to be a play action.
Leg under center. Play action pass. Leg has time. Now rolls out to his left. Wants to take off again, and he's going to be sacked. Carmine's got to burn their final timeout. I mean, it seemed like as soon as Warren faked the play action, he tried to run.
Yeah, and you just can't. I mean, I know you're trying to make something happen, but you've got to get it downfield. The Wolves are expecting it, you know, so, but I mean, you've got to get it downfield.
14.7 seconds on the clock.
And maybe time for two plays. If we don't get this, then it's, you have to complete this because there's not a desperation heave from, you know, 62 yards away. So you have to get some kind of positive yardage here if you can complete even a 25, 30-yarder, you know, get it to mid, somewhat of a Hail Mary type range.
Again, you have no timeouts, so if you do get a first down, it's...
You got to spike it.
Spike it if you can, if there's any time left. And if it's a pass play for Warren Leg, you can't run. Running's no option here. If it's not there, you got to throw it away.
Yeah.
Third down and 11 for Carmi from their own 38-yard line. 30-24. Flora leads with 14 seconds to play. Under center is Leg. Leg will take the snap. Back to pass. Warren with time. Throws one near sideline. Incomplete. Looking for Jackson Arden. Here we go. Final play of the game coming up.
Barring any miracle, that's going to do it.
It's a good thing Drax didn't catch that, because if he did, the clock would have ran out.
Yeah.
So normally in the NFL, you see a little 10-yard hitch route, then a lateral, another lateral, and I'm not sure if Carmine's got anything like that.
No.
And again, Chris, I mean, I think 99% of the population didn't think that they would need that with 8 seconds to play.
No.
Play clock's down to 10. Carmine might not get a snap off here. If they do, they're going to have to take a 5-yard penalty, and they will. This could be a delay game.
Yeah, I mean, this went from bad to worse.
So Carmine will back it up 5 more yards. Not that it really matters that much. I mean,
no, in this case,
if you get tackled at the 1-yard line here, then you'll think about it. But
and Coach Simon is way out there on the field, you know, relaying the play. It's not a timeout situation, so.
8.5 seconds on the clock. Carmine has no timeouts. They've got 72 yards to go to avoid one of the biggest upset losses in a long time. Greg will pass. He'll roll to his right. Final play of the game right here. Warren's going to throw down the field. The pass is going to be incomplete, and that will do it. The Florida Wolves will keep their season alive for another week. They come into Carmine and they upset the Bulldogs 30-24.
And you got to credit them.
Yeah,
you really do. You have to credit Flora. They had a good game plan coming in here. Tolliver has just, I mean, if he hadn't gotten a lot of recognition before tonight, he's going to.
Yep.
He is an electric football player.
It really, I mean, Chris, I can't. How is this team only 5-4? I mean,
how did they lose to, you know, not to take anything from Hamco, but
how
I
did
just.
They lose to Hamilton County?
Yeah.
You know, I just.
It's just baffling to me, you know, because they're as good as, you know, anyone we've seen.
Yeah.
You know, I think it
all comes down to this was their playoff game.
It was.
This was their.
They played
you know,
like
and I can tell you what, no matter what happens, you know, obviously they're going to be. They're going to be traveling to play somebody 9-0 next week, and they might not win.
Yeah.
But I can tell you what, when 30 years down the road, they'll think about this game, and this will be their playoff game for them.
Absolutely. This was their chance to play spoiler. This is their chance to extend their season. They played like a team fighting for their very lives tonight. And to their credit, they came in here a game no one outside of Flora gave them a chance to win. And they came in, they not only won, they did it in a convincing fashion.
Yep.
This wasn't a fluke play, went the last minute. This was, they controlled this game from basically the second quarter on. You know, Carmine showed finally a spark of life getting the score there with on the long pass play there midway through the fourth. But when our defense needed to rise up and get them back off the field, we couldn't. You know, and a lot of that you credit their scheme, but that Malachi Tolliver. How many times was it 3rd and 12? Even a couple fourth downs, and he was just, you know, put everybody on my back. I'll carry you.
Yep.
He was that guy tonight, and credit them. But I still think the residual effects of that loss last week, you could tell it was still kind of on us,
yep.
Especially on the defensive side of the football. You know, I just don't think we ever mentally recovered from last week. And Flora took advantage of that. They came out ready to play. We were flat. And Flora walks away with a win tonight.
Okay, in the final score, Flora wins it 30-24. The Wolves get that crucial win number 5 on the season, and they will go to the playoffs. And they will decide their fate. They'll learn their fate just like Carmine will tomorrow night during the playoff pairing show. We'll take a 3-minute break. When we come back, we'll have the Roark Transport postgame show right here on 97.3 WRUL.
post-game show is delivered thanks to all our transport hauling fuels, rock, grain, and more to help our community grow. Call 265-3665 for more information. Cole Carter and Chris Myers. Again, the Bulldogs back-to-back weeks with tough losses, but this one just a stunner more than anything. Carmine falls to Flora, 30-24, and the Wolves will improve their record to 5-4. They will advance to the postseason, while Carmine, obviously, you're still going to the playoffs, but you talked about it, Chris. We're back into the playoffs.
Yeah, the thing you didn't want to happen, you know, you knew the Johnson City game was going to be, you know, go either way type matchup. But coming into tonight, this is something I don't think anybody saw in the whole conference, us for sure, our fans, and not the way you want to end the season. But again, you are in the playoffs, so you do have a chance to pick yourself up and move on, fortunately, and that's what the Bulldogs have to do.
Now being joined by head coach Kurt Simon, and coach, obviously a game that people didn't really see coming, but you got to tip your cap to Flora on the way they played.
I have no question about it. They came to play, and they were playing for their playoff lives, and I give them all the credit in the world. They came out and shoved us around the whole game. We started out doing some okay things offensively, but we just couldn't put the stop on them. The quarterback had a really nice game. They did a good job. They ran the ball really effectively, and we couldn't get them off the field.
Yeah. Can you talk about, for them, Malachi Tolliver? He was kind of – where did this
get slippery.
He was fantastic.
Yeah, he was.
Was that something you were expecting from him?
Yeah, I mean, he's done that this year. He's not quite as good as he did it tonight, but I just give them all the credit in the world. And you know, it's just something that we just have to learn from, you know. You know, there's a lot of people putting their pads up this weekend. We're not.
Right.
Okay. And you know, we had a tough one a week ago. I had a tough one tonight. You're going to have a tough one in the playoffs because they're always tough. So you just got to get used to playing with that physicality, with that type of physicality if you want to win these types of games. And we didn't make enough plays tonight to do it. So.
Yeah, it's a tough spot to be in. Talked about last week losing that game. It felt like a season-ending loss just with the way the game was. But you guys, again, you have a lot to play for. You're still going to
absolutely
have a good seed next week and a chance to win a couple of playoff games. But you got to imagine it's going to be tough for these kids to put these past 2 weeks behind them.
Well, and that's where character comes into it. We'll find out what kind of character we have, you know. Last week we knew it was going to be a difficult game against a real physical team. And we knew that Flora was always capable because, just last week against Cesar, the Cesar didn't score in the second half. And Flora was on the goal line twice and didn't get in, and they were on about the one. I mean, they very easily could have, you know, take down Cesar last week, too. So you got to prepare every week the same way. And like you said, look at the film, learn what we can, and just, again, this comes down to what kind of character we have. We had a great season going where we hadn't lost a game. Now we've got, you know, two of them back to back, and of course it's hard to swallow. We're not used to seeing that this year, but we'll see how we do now. Now we really got to pick it up and play better, because like I said, the next games from here on out in this second season, when you get in the playoffs, they're all good.
Yeah.
So,
and not to belabor the point, Coach, but you know, I just talk from here. I talk about maybe the emotional toll from last week might have carried in a little this week. I know you guys are going to put it behind you. And what's the message you tell your team this week? You know, you'll find out your opponent tomorrow. But regardless, what's the message you tell your team going
forward? Well, I mean, the message is basically just what I said, and that's what I just said to them. Now we really find out what kind of character we have as a group. You know, you guys around, all your buddies, and what we've done as a team this year, and all the work you've put into it, you know, this is a good test for us now, you know, mentally and physically. I know we got to get, you know, Gavin Payton got hurt tonight and didn't play three quarters of the game, which didn't help. You know, one of your best linemen, and hopefully we can get him back and healthy. But it's just a matter of, you know, keeping your nose, you know, and your eyes looking forward and working hard at it. We've still got a good football team.
Yes.
And we've done a lot of good things this year. But, you know, we were faced with some adversity now. You know, we thought we were staring at a home playoff game for sure. Now I'd say we're probably on the road. But that's the way it goes. That doesn't mean that you can't, you know, have a great week of preparation and learn from these last two weeks. And, you know, we don't like this feeling. And we got to really work at it to not have this feeling again after next week.
Yeah, regardless, you're in the postseason. Great season. As Cole will recap, we'll find out who we play next week and wish you all the best.
We'll get after it. We'll get after it.
Thanks for your time,
Coach.
Thanks. Can the Bulldogs fall tonight? 30-24 to Flora. So both teams will play next week, and like Coach said, Carmi could be at home, could be on the road next week. Yeah. It all comes down to who else won tonight, who else lost, who's going to be considered 2A, who's going to be considered 1A or 3A. Just a lot of components that are going to go into it. But again, we'll find that out tomorrow night. But Chris, what do you do? You know, I think that's kind of the thing. If you're Bulldog fans, you're kind of asking yourselves right now. Like Coach said, this is a really good football team, and I think there's a lot of components that went into this loss tonight, and I think it's a lot. I think you combine last week's loss, you combine the senior night where it's a little bit of a different feel, and you combine the fact that you played a team who was fighting for their lives, and they should.
Yeah.
And I think it's going to be tough for these kids to kind of swallow this one and move on. But again, this might be the better for them. They might get a better draw out of their 7-2. They might play a more beatable team. Now, you just never know. But
yeah.
Regardless, you've got to shake it off. And at this point, everybody's 0-0.
Well, again, I just think from my personal view that a lot of the residual mental wear and tear was still on this team. Mm-hmm. You could see it tonight. They just didn't have, I'm not saying that they didn't come out wanting to play. They just didn't have their normal passion,
intensity.
Their normal intensity. Yeah. That's the better word, the intensity that this team has played with, the defense especially, you know. And I think, really, we talk about football as a game of inches, a game of momentum. Those two bounced passes kept Flora alive.
Yeah.
On their first score, just a crazy tip. Odd tipped it. Driscoll tipped it. We thought we're going to pick it. They get a first down out of it. That little thing gave them enough spark to get it in the end zone. Next possession, I mean, they throw a long bomb for all intents and purposes. We thought it's picked. He gets just enough of behind. The ball bounces off his helmet. As he's falling to the ground, the receiver catches it. Two fluke plays just kept the spark in him enough to create an entire where they were on fire, literally. And I think when those things happen, after they scored that second touchdown, you could just see it in the body language of our defense, like, here we go again.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we had these two things happen last week against Johnson City, those two big fullback runs. And after those plays happened, our defense was just kind of looking at each other like, what's going on?
Mm-hmm.
Same thing tonight. Once those two fluke bounces happened and they scored, you could see our boys looking at each other, that same look. And from that point, you just never had the feeling that the Bulldogs just had had their normal mojo, and it was a perfect storm. It was a perfect storm, and that was the only concern, you know. And I'm as guilty as anyone. I fully expect us to come out here and take business. Take care of business tonight. But this Florida team, you heard Coach Simon say it. I was just like, where has this Tolliver kid been in the conversations all year?
Yep.
And he just played out of his mind tonight. That 6'3", 190-pound, just complete athlete. How many times tonight, Cole, at least three or four, third and longs, where four guys had him wrapped up. It was fourth down. It was fourth down, and he broke it, led him to another scoring drive. That's the drive that put him on top. And just things that haven't happened to the Bulldogs this year. And you can see one thing we're going to have to do. We're going to have to mix in a few more passes into our offense, because you see what happens when we fall behind, when our running game's not going. You know, you got to have some kind of option. So, again, the good thing is these boys have earned the right to be in the playoffs. They've had a great season. These last 2 weeks have not been indicative of what they've done all year. So another chance to pick yourself up. You're in the postseason. Put this behind you and just start fresh. It's a great opportunity.
Yep. The bounce back report comes your way thanks to the good folks at Wabash Christian Therapy on Oak Street in Carmi. Get back in the game. Call Wabash Christian today. And again, Chris, Bulldogs really do have to bounce back. And this time it's you have to, or else your season's over. And again, we have no idea who we're going to face next week. And with this loss tonight, really makes you think we have no idea who we're going to play. But there's no question whoever comes to
Carmine next week or wherever we go next week, it's going to be a good football team.
No question. I mean, from here on out, it's Johnson City level quality football team.
Absolutely.
From here on out. So there is no after this week regroup. There is no we'll get them next week. It's win or go home.
Yep.
But again, you're glad for the Bulldogs that they've earned the right to get in the postseason. But what you want to see us change is just regathering ourselves, getting that magic back offensively, especially the defense. The defense has to regroup no matter who we play, gain some confidence, and just come up and start making stops again, because that's going to be critical. It's how well we play defense going into the postseason, because mistakes can't happen against good football teams.
In the final score, Bulldogs fall to 7-2. They end the regular season at 7-2, while Flora is going to sneak into the playoffs with a record of 5-4. And again, tomorrow night, the Bulldogs will find out their playoff fate during the IHSA playoff pairing show. You can watch that at 8 o'clock on the NFHS Network. I believe it's also going to be shown on WSIL Channel 3. So a chance to watch live when the Bulldogs will get their draw for next weekend. And we'll have a Saturday morning sports show for you tomorrow at 9 a.m. to give you some kind of preview of who the Bulldogs could possibly see, and looking ahead to what's going on next week in terms of Bulldog and Lady Bulldog athletics. Well, that's going to wrap things up for us here tonight. A big thanks to J.C. Tinsley and Whitney McGuire getting us up on the YouTube live stream. And a big thanks to Scott Mehring back at the WRUO studio getting us on the air. For Chris Myers, I'm Cole Carter. Have a great weekend, Bulldog fans.